Everybody's hilarious. Well, you bunch of racist, bigoted, white supremacists, haters of humanity. How dare you support Donald Trump? Don't you know what this says about you? They love the word hate, don't they? They're in love with hate. Is this the sleaziest, slimiest, most grotesque presidential campaign season you've ever seen? Or are you from Botswana? I think those are the two choices. I don't mean to pick on Botswana. It could be Burkina Faso or Uzbekistan or a whole range of places, even Venezuela at this point. Amazing. That's amazing. Speaking of Venezuela, the other day, day before yesterday, I read a story from the papers. It was right there in the papers about the Venezuelan government of Nicolas Maduro, who, of course, took over the revolution, took the reins of the revolution from the late Hugo Chavez, although his Hugo Chavez's daughter is still, I believe, the wealthiest person in Venezuela, which is kind of handy because she's a hardworking young woman and she's earned every billion she has. No doubt. I'm sure that that's the case. Nicolas Maduro's government announced that they were, well, they handed out a directive, actually, to their government agencies and departments and so on, that anyone that has signed a petition opposing Nicolas Maduro should be immediately fired from their job with extreme prejudice and cast out into the street to eat house pets with the rest of the recipients of the glories of the revolution. And I talked about the story, and that very specific directives that if you don't support Nicolas Maduro, that if you signed any petitions opposing Nicolas Maduro, calling for a recall election, that you should be fired, and that the bosses and all of the government agencies should locate people, identify people that don't support the current president, and that those people should be fired. And I thought of that story again this morning when I was going through the news, and I saw that CNN just fired Dr. Drew. Did you see that CNN just fired Dr. Drew? He had a show on Who Watches CNN on Headline News, the headline news service of CNN. Had his own Dr. Drew. You remember him? He used to have a, ABC show or something like that, and he went to CNN. But his big mistake, apparently, some are conjecturing, far be it for me, once again, to assume that I know why they fired Dr. Drew, but it was just several days after Dr. Drew went on a radio show in Los Angeles, California, and suggested that he is gravely concerned, those were his words, about Hillary's health. He was concerned about Hillary's health, he said on a radio show, and he said that the situation was bizarre and that her medical condition might be dangerous, and it was concerning. And he said that some of her behavior and the things were... Do you have the... I think we've got the audio right there, in fact, of Dr. Drew talking about this on the... What is it? McIntyre in the Morning show in Los Angeles, California. And he made the mistake of going on the radio and saying that he was concerned about Hillary Clinton's health. And then just days later, he lost his job. He was fired. And I played the audio just earlier this week of CNN, a montage. I think we did a montage, in fact. Was it a montage? That's a French word also. A montage of all the people at CNN saying how this is just a conspiracy theory, and other networks too, but lots and lots of CNN. It's conspiracy, the conspiracy theories, and Trump is peddling conspiracy theories about Hillary's health, and Rudy Giuliani, and conspiracy theories, conspiracy theories. Whereas none of the news media is looking into Hillary's this or that. They're just reading the press release that was handed to them by the Clinton campaign. And I don't know what her health situation is like, but I can tell you she doesn't look real good to me. That could just be me. But Dr. Drew walked out on a limb, grave concern for her health, said there are some indicators. Talked to a friend of his who is a doctor and medical expert, as the news media likes to call people. And his friend said that he's concerned about Hillary's health. And so Dr. Drew Pinsky, that's his name, Dr. Drew Pinsky, said that he's concerned about Hillary's health. And boom, he's gone. He's out of there. He's fired. And I don't know why that reminded me of Venezuela. And all of the opponents of Nicolas Maduro being fired from their government jobs. But for some reason, it did remind me of that. Gosh, I can't imagine why. But he did lose his job, interestingly enough. And this is a story that we're going to get it, obviously. Hillary Clinton's big speech yesterday afternoon, which I watched and was marveling at. It is a filthy business, and no one in their right mind would want to spend their lives battling the scum that you have to battle to become president of the United States, which explains our current situation to some degree or another. And the long knives are out for Donald Trump, as usual, I suppose, in the news media. And Jeb Bush came out, did a radio interview yesterday with Rita Cosby. And Jeb Bush is not very amused with the change in tone. It's the change in tone from Donald Trump having to do with illegal aliens and all of that good stuff, or undocumented Americans, I think CNN calls them now. And I want to get into that. There's a great deal of other news today, of course, having to do with Hillary Clinton and deleted emails and their shredder system that they have for destroying emails, and Trey Gowdy and all of that good stuff, and plenty more as well. I've come up with a new bumper sticker. My bumper sticker the other day was, "If you can read this, you're a racist," which is kind of a fun bumper sticker. But my new bumper sticker is, "No, comma, you're a racist." Just good. Since we're all going around calling each other racist, it's what the Democrats have done. This is what the Democrats have done. Donald Trump is a terrible racist. Everybody that supports him is a terrible racist. Only white supremacists support him. And it's an amazing time in which we live. I'm kind of disgusted by it, revulsed by it, appalled by it. And gosh, I don't know. Hillary Clinton and the news media, the juggernaut continues. Donald Trump and Viva la Illegal Immigracion also continues to trundle along. And I want to get into all of this stuff this morning. And all the hate groups and stuff. And the news media asking Donald Trump, "Do you want white supremacists to vote for you?" I like that one. That's a good one. You know, anybody remember the name Omar Mateen? Omar Mateen. Ring a bell? Omar Mateen is the troglodyte radical Islamic jihadi that massacred 49 people at the Pulse nightclub in Orlando, Florida, and a Hillary supporter. He's dead now. He may still vote for her because Florida's an important state, and if he's registered, he may just show up and cast a ballot, even though he's gone on to his maker where he's gotten his 72 raisins. So, 72 raisins. 72 raisins? Yes, yeah, 72 raisins. On to his reward. Omar Mateen, a Hillary Clinton supporter, according to one of his best pals that was interviewed, it was in the New York Times, that he was a Hillary supporter and his pal was a Bernie supporter. So he's a lefty that hung out with lefties, and then he murdered all those people in the name of the jihad. But he was a Hillary supporter. Hillary, even though Omar Mateen is dead, would you like his vote? How about his lovely and adoring wife, who has apparently disappeared from the planet Earth? Would you like her vote? Jared Loeffner, who shot Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords in the head, murdered a federal judge and a 9-year-old girl, shot up a bunch of other people. Big lib, big supporter of President Obama, but never mind that, because we wouldn't want to play that guilt by association game. The Communist Party USA has representatives of the party have endorsed Hillary Clinton. Where does the Nation of Islam stand on this, with Louis Farrakhan listed as a hate group by the so-called Southern Poverty Law Center, which is three butt-scratching morons dwelling in a basement that the news media pretends is the Harvard School of Law? How about Black Lives Matter? I believe that Black Lives Matter whipped people with the guy that murdered five police officers in Dallas and shot many more. Black Lives Matter guy, you think Hillary supporter or a Trump guy? What do you, Trump guy? Or or what? Jeremiah Wright? Is Jeremiah Wright, he's an anti-Semite, a racist, anti-American Hillary supporter? I'm thinking he's probably a Hillary supporter. And the news media going to be asking whether Hillary wants Jeremiah Wright's vote, whether she wants the votes of the rioters in Ferguson and in Baltimore and the racists in Milwaukee that targeted white people. Hillary, you want their votes? Because these are your voters. This is your base. This is your core. These are your voters. You got, 91% of the African-American vote. So I'm thinking that these are your voters. But the news media will not confront Hillary Clinton with that. They will, however, confront Donald Trump. There's a reporter that doorstepped Donald Trump. He talks to every reporter that walks by. And a reporter asked Donald Trump this question.
She's trying to turn this around on you now, saying you're bringing a hate movement mainstream. Do you want white supremacists to vote for you?
No, I don't at all. Not at all. And I will tell you, this is not about hate. This is about love. We love our country. We want our country to come back. We want our country to be strong again.
Love, love, love. Boom, 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 boom. It's not about hate, it's about love. But the Democrats are great at this. They're great at the smear. Hillary was very much in her element yesterday. She was right at home calling everybody racist. And I'm not sure how many Americans she called racist yesterday, but tens of millions, certainly, of Americans she called racist. And she wants to associate, and this is the Democrats, again, they've done an excellent job, and it's taken decades. And I've been talking about this for years, but the Democrats have engaged in a decades-long smear campaign of their mortal enemies, the Republicans. Not the jihadis, not the Soviet Union, not totalitarianism, but the Republicans, who they are so brimming with hatred and disdain for. They are so dripping with contempt for their next-door neighbors, for their fellow Americans, for apparently white people. They've got a problem with white people. The Democrats do have a problem with white people. They've got a problem with America. They've got a problem with people that wave the flag. They've got a problem with people that talk about the Constitution, talk about preserving America, because they don't like America. They see America. They do the 10 Things I Hate About You analysis of American history, the Howard Zinn analysis of American history, and they want to fundamentally transform, to borrow a phrase, the United States of America into something that it is not or was not before. And I got to tell you, it's so awful out there. It's just, I watched it yesterday and I just shook my head and I said, look what happened to our nice country. Look what they've done. Look what they've done to the Democrat Party. Look what's happened to the Republican Party. This is an amazing time in which we live. And white supremacists, is that right? It's classic guilt by association and smear tactics. And that's their wheelhouse. That's what they do. It's the decades-long smear. And over time, it works. I was at dinner last night with a couple of friends. And one friend is a liberal person, Obama supporter, all that stuff, and I love her. She's a great friend, been friends for decades. And she said that Mike Pence is a radical and an extremist, an extreme right-winger, because of the Indiana Religious Liberties Bill. And that's it. And it's, I'm talking about this recently, the background noise, the din, the Democrats, the left control the background noise between Jimmy Kimmel and the list goes on, Comedy Central and so on. If you don't really follow politics closely and all you get is the maelstrom of mass media inputs every day, in the end, you're going to be left with this impression, a generally negative impression of the Republican Party, of Abraham Lincoln, of actually getting the Civil Rights Bill passed. They love to give LBJ credit for it, but the Democrats would have did filibuster Civil Rights Act, Voting Rights Act 64-65. And it's just their history is the most appalling history. And I am shaking my head today. I'm shaking my head. We are at at 888-630-9625. 888-630-9625 is the telephone number here. It's also Hillary Clinton's prisoner ID number. She is convict number 888-630-9625. And if you don't believe me, go to our Facebook page and or the WMAL website page, the Chris Plant page, and you'll see the photos there of Hillary Clinton in her prison garb with the number 888-630-9625 on her orange jumpsuit. And there's another one with her holding up the plaque with our phone number on it, 888-630-9625.
You're listening to The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
And now a look at WMAL traffic around the Virginia Beltway. Just still can't shake these delays on the inner loop, leaving the toll road heading toward the American Legion Bridge. Crews are looking for an incident before the bridge span. On the northbound side of the George Washington Parkway, also slow to merge on to that stretch of the Beltway. Maryland, 95, southbound. As you approach the Patuxent, we're doing okay this morning. It's going to be northbound approaching the Patuxent, where they were trying to set up some road work. And now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Plenty of sunshine today, 97, partly cloudy, 77 overnight.
Built for business. Waiting. No one enjoys it. With Comcast Business, you can do less of it. Because Comcast Business Internet is up to 5 times faster than DSL from the phone company, which means less waiting for things like security backups and file downloads. Plus, it's a better value when you select the fastest plan. So do what nearly 1,000 businesses do every day and choose Comcast Business. Unless you'd prefer to wait. Switch to Comcast Business Internet. Then add one voice line and TV for just $34.90 a month for 2 years. And ask about their low price guarantee. Call 800-501-6000 or visit ComcastBusiness.com. That's 800-501-6000. Comcast Business. Built for business.
Offer ends 8/31/16. Restrictions apply. Equipment, taxes, and fees, including broadcast TV fee extra. Compares Comcast 100 megabits per second and 20 megabits per second DSL downloads.
Welcome to a place where all that glitters is yours for the taking. You can win a share of $70,000 in trips, cash, and more at the $70,000 kickoff giveaway on August 26th and August 27th. Start earning entries now. There's no place like Hollywood. Hollywood Casino at Charlestown Races. All gaming is regulated by the West Virginia Lottery. Gamble too much? Call 1-800-522-4700 for free confidential help.
How would you like to make up to $20,000 a month flipping houses with no risk? Hi, my name is Nick Fertucci, and over the last 2 years, my elite team of house flippers have flipped over 800 properties by using my three-step flipping system that guarantees quick profits. And this year, we plan to double it. I'm growing my team in your area, and I'm looking for help. I have more cash available than deals right now, so I need you. All interested candidates, call now and take an inside peek of my flipping system. I'll rush you out a free copy of my Fortunes in Flipping CD kit that will show you how easy it is to get in, get out, and get paid immediately flipping houses if you come join my team.
Call 1-800-614-9297 now to get your free flipping kit. Call 800-617-9297 and you'll also get free tickets to a training workshop that includes a free meal, a smartphone watch, and USB flash drive loaded with Nick's powerful information as free gifts just for attending. Call 800-614-9297. That's 800-614-9297. Call now.
Not available in all states.
Whoa, what do you have there?
It's a Reason Irvy's frozen yogurt. We just had our robot make one.
A robot made your frozen yogurt?
Yes, the world's first fully interactive robot vending machine that serves 9 flavors of delicious yogurt with 6 amazing toppings. And it's available for an exclusive franchise opportunity.
How do I get my own Reason Irvy's robots?
It's easy, but you better act now. Locations and machines are going fast. Just go to froyofranchising.com. That's froyofranchising.com. Check it out now, froyofranchising.com.
Is your air conditioner not keeping your home and family cool during these hot summer months? Are those high energy bills taking a toll on your wallet? If so, call ARS Rescue Router. We're offering select heating and cooling systems at a low monthly cost of only $83 with approved credit. That's right. For a limited time, you can have energy-efficient comfort for only $83 a month. For details and to schedule your free estimate, call 888-2424-ARS or visit arsofvirginia.com.
Call ARS and Rescue Router. Message and data rates may apply.
Hi, I'm Frank Thomas. When I was playing ball, they called me the Big Hurt. But after I left the game, Mother Nature started putting a big hurt on me. I just couldn't stay in shape like I used to. Turns out, it wasn't my fault. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone, and that can make it harder to get into shape. But luckily, I found out about Nugenix.
Nugenix is a unique man-boosting formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help boost your free testosterone levels. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting ENERGY to 67076. With Nugenix, you can feel stronger, leaner, with a lot more stamina and energy.
And guys, she'll like the difference too.
Nugenix is GNC's number one selling men's vitality product. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting ENERGY to 67076. Nugenix samples are not available in stores. So again, text ENERGY to 67076.
Mark Levin lights up the lines weeknights at 6 on Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
Today, our country has lost a true American original, my friend and mentor, Robert C. Byrd. Senator Byrd was a man of surpassing eloquence and nobility, and I will remember him for many things. It is almost impossible to imagine the United States Senate without Robert Byrd. He was not just its longest-serving member. He was its heart, its soul, and its historian.
And its pointy hat.
From my first day in the Senate, I sought out his guidance, and he was always generous with his time and his wisdom.
And if you ever needed a napkin, he always had one, because he's Robert C. Byrd, the exalted cyclops of the Democratic Party there on Capitol Hill. If you ever forget your pointy white hat at home, Senator Byrd was always there to help you out. If you ever needed a piece of rope or Senator Byrd was there, her mentor, she loved that guy, the exalted cyclops. He founded the KKK in West Virginia. It's good to be a Democrat, isn't it? Man, it's a parallel universe over there. Hey, what's the problem? I was just the exalted cyclops of the KKK for several decades, and I founded the KKK in West Virginia, didn't exist there until I created it, and now I'm Hillary Clinton's favorite person ever. I'm her mentor. She's my seamstress. I give her sheets. She gives me back a completed Sunday go-to-meeting suit. An aerodynamic hat. With a nice embroidered exalted cyclops thing. One of her favorite people.
This is the Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
Crash on the Virginia Beltway inner loop right as you approach the George Washington Parkway, now out of the travel lanes, but pressure is still on. The delays from the toll road and eastbound on the toll road merging into those backups. 66, we're good outside of the Beltway. Inside the Beltway, we're jammed through Falls Church. On a Laurel stretch of 95, watch for delays near 198 going north toward the Patuxent, where they're setting up road work. And now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Plenty of sunshine today, 97, partly cloudy, 77 overnight.
Traffic and weather brought to you by Hadid Carpet Cleaning.
At Hadid Cleaning Services, we know pets are part of the family, and accidents happen.
Your rugs and carpets need a deep-down professional clean.
You need Hadid.
Right now, get our best deal ever.
Clean two rugs, get an equal or lesser rug cleaned for free.
For details, go to JoeHadid.com.
The kids need braces. The house is expensive. College is right around the corner. And retirement? It's looking cloudy at best right now. How can you ensure that you'll have enough when it's time? Hi, this is Greg Smith, co-host of WMAL's Wise Investor Show. Call us and learn how we can help you better achieve your financial goals.
Greg Smith and the Wise Investor Group are affiliated with Robert W. Baird & Company. To reach Greg, call 1-866-758-9473 or log on to thewiseinvestorgroup.com and resolve to become a better informed wise investor.
Hi, I'm Dr. Alex McMillan of McMillan Sedation Dentistry. I can provide a range of implant restorative treatment options in a single pain-free visit. Here are the advantages of choosing McMillan Sedation Dentistry. I have over 35 years of experience, hundreds of hours of advanced training and certification to use a nationally recognized state-of-the-art implant treatment. Implants? are a permanent and simple solution, the new standard of care for tooth replacement and denture stabilization. From a single missing tooth to an entire set of teeth, dental implants restore your appearance, speech, oral health, comfort, and self-esteem. With dental implants, we can also permanently replace your dentures, which means no more slippage or adhesives ever again. Smile big. Eat what you want. Call McMillan Sedation Dentistry today and make your appointment at 877-394-4511. Online at smileeasy.com. That's smileeasy.com.
Everybody has dreams. A fulfilling career, a happy home, and a checked-off bucket list. A scrapbook filled with travel photos, ticket stubs, and little moments of glory. Keepsake memories of a life well-lived. With an affordable quality education from an accredited state university, you can turn these dreams into reality. University of Maryland University College offers programs for in-demand fields such as business, cybersecurity, IT, healthcare, and more. By providing career-relevant skills taught by respected faculty practicing in the field, UMUC builds the confidence you need to set your career in motion. Online and on-site at more than 20 locations in the D.C. metro area, University of Maryland University College gives you the flexibility your busy schedule demands, while saving you time and money with credits earned from prior college, work, and military experience. For all you want, it has to be UMUC. Visit umuc.edu/radio or call 888-388-UMUC.
Get the news and information you want when you want it. Rivet Radio lets you hear one riveting story after another. Customize your news to hear only what's important to you. Download Rivet Radio for iPhone, Android, or Amazon Fire.
Listen every weekday morning at 5:42 for today's military news, brought to you by GEICO Military. These news reports come directly from the United States Department of Defense at defense.gov. For more information, visit WMAL.com and type in keyword today's. GEICO's military program has been an important part of their business since it began in 1936. GEICO understands the unique insurance needs of our military personnel and their families. That's why they provide a dedicated staff working solely on their behalf.
Want to know the secret that those flipping houses gurus won't tell you? Is that flipping multi-unit properties is easier and more profitable than flipping single-family homes. With over 17 years of experience, we here at RE Mentor will show you the art of buying and selling multi-unit properties. Come spend the afternoon or evening with our team of experts, and we will show you how to put $10,000 to $30,000 in your pocket over the next 90 days. This two-hour class will teach you the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. You'll learn how to buy, hold, and sell multi-unit properties with no money down, no credit, and no risk. You risk nothing but have everything to gain. This intensive two-hour real estate class is coming to the DMV area soon. Call 1-800-863-7614 to secure your seat now. This seminar is free for the first 30 people that call. Change your life now and learn the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. Call 1-800-863-7614. 1-800-863-7614. Call now.
105.9 FM and AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
Question I have for you Anglo-European Caucasian Americans, for, you don't have to be an American, you're going to be from another country, for African Americans, for people of African descent from all over the world, for Latinos, Hispanics, Aleuts, Eskimos, Aboriginals, to all of you out there. Did I leave out Asians? Asians, subcontinentals, Lincoln Continentals, everyone. Here's my question for you. What role does race have in this year's presidential election? What role do you see race playing in this year's presidential election? And that's my sort of overarching question for you, 888-630-9625. And then there's this question that I asked at the don't know if it was at the dinner table last night with friends or whether I just asked my best girl this question, because sometimes I just turn to her and I ask her ridiculous questions that you would probably never ask your wife or your husband. But I said, what is a president going to do that's going to be different for black people than it is for white people? Is there a president who's going to be, well, I'm going to be real good for black people? What does that even mean? That's kind of puzzling, isn't it? And now I'm, you know, more or less Caucasian, but I just don't understand how you can walk through the world in 2016 thinking that one president is going to be better for black people than the other president. He's a terrible racist. And Hillary Clinton said yesterday, white supremacist and a bigot. And did I mention a racist and a white supremacist? Because she said it over and over and over and over and over again yesterday. What's the, can you do a word count and see how many times she mentioned race or used the word racist in yesterday's thing? Is that a difficult thing to do? And I'm just pondering, you know, if I'm black, if I'm white, if I'm Latino, I know that the Democrats are planning on leaving our southern border wide open because George Soros wants them to, and they don't like America, the Democrats, so they want to leave our southern border wide open. And the consequences, well, they assume won't affect them, so that's okay with them, except on Election Day when they think it will be a net plus for them. So an open border for the United States, which the radical left likes, the worldwide radical left likes no borders. And in America, we have the Democrats to stand in for, to represent the radical left. And they don't like border security. They don't like enforcing immigration laws. So if you're illegally in the country, then the Democrats are for you. And if you're illegally in the country, the Democrats will register you to vote, and they will give you a ride to the polling place on Election Day if it works out that they can help you. They don't care about law. They don't care about borders. They don't care about culture. They don't care about language. They don't care about the United States. They care about themselves. I think that's abundantly clear at this point, isn't it? But I'm just puzzled and pondering how it is that people can think that the Democrats are good for black people, despite the decades, no, centuries of evidence. Let's just start with, gosh, I don't know, the Howard Zinn version of America. Andrew Jackson, Democrat, Trail of Tears. Jefferson Davis, Democrat, President of the Confederate States of America. Nathan Bedford Forrest, Democrat, founder of the KKK. Robert Byrd, Hillary Clinton just doing her homage to the exalted Cyclops of the KKK. Jim Crow, Democrat policies. Orville Faubus, standing in the schoolhouse door at Central High in Little Rock, Arkansas, Democrat. George Wallace, standing in the doorway, the University of Alabama, Democrat. Sheriff Bull Connor, fire hoses and attack dogs, elected Democrat, statewide Democrat Party leader at the national conventions, Democrat. Democrats, including Al Gore's father, Richard Russell of Georgia, filibustering the Civil Rights Bill and the Voting Rights Act under LBJ. LBJ saying, I'll have those racial slurs deleted, voting Democrat for the next 200 years. This is the Democrat Party, and that's their history. The Republicans, on the other hand, the opposite of that history, but never mind that. The Democrats, the party of the soft bigotry of low expectations, the party of Chicago, which has a homicide rate like Aleppo, Syria, the party that has run West Baltimore into the ground, Ferguson, Missouri, the party of Black Lives Matter, of riots, of killing cops, of 50% African-American abortion rate, of harvesting organs, the list goes on and on. And this is the party. And if you look at their successes in Chicago, in Ferguson, in Baltimore, and the list goes on. Let's look at Rudy Giuliani in New York and what happened to the homicide rate when he was mayor of New York. Let's look at the economy under Ronald Reagan. Oh, Bill Clinton Bill Clinton had the, he inherited 12 years of Reagan, H.W. Bush economic policies. Lucky him. And then, thanks to Al Gore, Bill Clinton also rode the internet wave, all of that good stuff. The economy was so much better. And I just look at this and I marvel. And the Democrats, and Trump said it yesterday, they have one card to play, and it's race. Race, race, race. They call you racists. That's what they do. They call the other guy racist. Now, Hillary Clinton went to this racist's party. Went to his wedding. Bill and Hillary went to this terrible, awful racist that she described yesterday. Why did she go to his wedding? If you want to do guilt by association, well, Hillary, if we're going to play this, 3 degrees of separation, 6 degrees of separation thing, then you're a racist by virtue of the fact that you went to Donald Trump's wedding and you hung out with him and you took donations from him because he did donate to Hillary Clinton's Senate campaign. He's donated to the Clinton Foundation. Why do they accept the donations? Are you that much of a whore for money, for donations, that you'll take your donations from racists? You'll take them from wherever you can get them? Her moral cup is empty. She's a very dishonest person. But I do want to ask, what role does race play in presidential politics? And how is one president going to be better for one race than another president? I marvel at that. What is it, because they're the party of welfare and black people need more welfare? I can't think of anything more racist than that, but I believe that's what the Democrats are peddling. The government is going to look out for you based on your race, but we're not going to look out for Whitey based on his race. Is that what the Democrats are saying? We're going to leave the border open because we know Latinos don't believe in borders and immigration laws? Is that what the Democrat Party position is on this? Let me go to the telephones. Let's go to Bob in Herndon. Bob, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Hello and good morning.
Good morning, Bob.
Yes, I am a Democrat. I believe America is great, and don't go around saying America isn't great.
Yeah.
I think your history of...
Who does go around saying America isn't great?
Trump. America isn't great right now.
Oh, is that what he says?
He says make America great again, because it's not great now, apparently.
Yeah. Well, I've got something Hillary said yesterday that said she wants to make America not racist again or something, but we'll get to that. I'm familiar with the party-issued talking points, but go right ahead.
Your history of race is skewed at best. I mean, when you...
What part of what I said isn't true?
What you say, all that stuff you said about the Democrats and the history was prior to 1964, when Strom Thurmond was a Dixiecrat and a Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
Once the Democrats embraced cultural diversity and racial diversity in the Civil Rights Act, mm-hmm. all those
well, they didn't. They didn't embrace the Civil Rights Act.
Well, Strom Thurmond left and went to the Republican Party, who embraced him. Now, Robert Byrd was in the KKK. He renounced it. He has renounced it over and over and spent the rest of his life apologizing for it. And
really? Did he? I never saw him apologize for it.
Every interview, he constantly apologized.
How about Harry Reid saying of Barack Obama Obama doesn't have a Negro accent unless he wants one?
Strom Thurmond never apologized. Republicans embraced him, and Strom Thurmond never apologized.
Well, the Democrats, he never apologized. That's false.
You're
revisionist, and I'm familiar with the old Southern strategy two-step that the Democrats conjured up in an effort to wash the blood off their hands.
When did he apologize?
When did he apologize? Well, I'm not actually the author of the Strom Thurmond biography, nor are you the author of the Robert Byrd biography. But he gave up racism, as a lot of people did in that era, and he became a Republican because the Democrats went so crazy. I challenge you to find it. And I love this apology thing. He wasn't the exalted Cyclops of the KKK either, which Robert Byrd was. So I guess he's got a lot more apologizing to do. And Strom Thurmond he wasn't the founding father of the KKK anywhere. But nevertheless, let me see if you can address the question that's on the table. What role does race play in this year's presidential election? And how will one president be better for one race than the other president?
Honestly, I'm not sure race plays more of a part in this election than prior elections, but I do think it is more overt. I think when you have a candidate who multiple times, transfers, white nationalist tweets and images, not just accidentally, but multiple times, that's a little weird.
I'd say there's one instance that I'm aware of that happening, and I think it was an incredibly stupid thing to do. I think now this whole thing, the Star of David thing, that's just a fabrication. That's
on
just
money.
That's
Star of David on top of a pile of money. You see nothing wrong with
it. You're fabricating or you're buying into the thing. It's a sheriff's badge, and it's quite obvious what it is.
On a pile of money.
That sure. It's
a,
you go right. Back and look at it again and tell me it's not a sheriff's badge. I know what the Democrat Party talking points are, but
okay, what can the president do? The main thing I see them doing is voting rights.
What's wrong with voting rights in 2016 in America?
There is no voter fraud in this country.
I know. There's no problem with having an ID on election day, right?
Actually, there is.
Because poor black people are too stupid to get driver's licenses.
There is nothing about stupidity. It is about it's difficult. It can be difficult for some people. And
really, like who?
Not necessary to vote.
Is that right? You got to have an ID for absolutely everything, right? And you saw that the Gallup polling organization found the other day that 80% of Americans are in favor of voter ID, including, dare I say, 77% of people of color in favor of ID on voting day from the Gallup polling organization. Did you see
having that? Having an ID isn't a right or a requirement. Voting is a right.
It's a requirement to cash a check. It's a requirement to open a bank account. It's a requirement to have cable TV.
It's a requirement
to have a phone. It's a requirement to get on an airplane, and that's the federal government, the TSA. It's a requirement to live in the United States of America to have a photo ID.
No, it's not.
And to set
it's
the
really
bar
not.
So low, homeless people have cell phones in the United States of America. Are you kidding me? You really think you're protecting voting rights by saying you shouldn't have to have an ID? And to say I grew up in Chicago, all right, and Bob, I have relatives that have personally signed up tombstones to vote on election day because they work for the Daily Machine in Chicago. Because you sound like a reasonably learned person, that in 1960, for example, the Kennedy campaign and Mayor Daley stole Illinois through a variety of means, that Joe Kennedy, the senior, bought West Virginia and the unions, and he said famously, "I'm not paying for a landslide here," and all that. So you know that this is a time-honored tradition for the Democrats.
You have to reach back almost 60 years.
Almost 60. No, I can go to Pennsylvania and Ohio in 2012 if you'd like to see some really interesting statistical irregularities where more than 100% of the registered voters voted and there were no votes for Mitt Romney in certain voting districts and so on. There are plenty of irregularities, and I've spoken
to
that's not an irregularity, and I've spoken to people on the phone right on this show who have worked for the Democrat Party in Milwaukee, in particular one story I remember where they were busing homeless people and picking people up off of Skid Row and getting them registered to vote same day and then giving them cigarettes and stuff to vote for the Democrats. This is common practice, and to pretend that it doesn't happen. Go ahead, Bob.
There are precincts where Mitt Romney got zero votes. There are also precincts where Obama got zero votes.
No, there aren't.
Voter fraud? Yes, there are.
There are
at least 18 districts that Obama got zero votes in very conservative places. That's not voter fraud. Out of all the districts, out of the hundreds of districts, yes, there are a handful where one candidate
I can't litigate this into the ground, but what is Hillary Clinton going to do for black people that Donald Trump's not going to do for black people?
Like I said, the main thing I'm concerned about is establishing voter rights for everybody,
right.
Which...
That's it. All right. We just beat that in. Is there anything else, Bob?
I do think they do support programs that disproportionately help African-Americans.
Disproportionately.
Yeah.
Like Planned Parenthood?
I don't know that one helps black people more.
You don't think that one helps black people? Well, they got a 60% abortion rate in New York City for African-Americans. That's a Democrat success story. Got 50%, nearly 50% abortion rate African-Americans nationwide. So is that a Democrat success story? Hillary Clinton has an award from Planned Parenthood, the Margaret Sanger Award. So they got that going for them. That's pretty good stuff, don't you think, Bob?
Honestly, I'm in favor of abortion rights and giving women the right.
I'm in favor of abortion rights and giving women the right. Yeah, I know. I don't know. 77% of people of color, according to Gallup, in favor of voter ID. But it's all about voter fraud. That's what it is. Voter suppression. That's what it is.
There's only one Chris Plant. The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall. WMAL. Where Washington comes to talk.
Virginia Beltway, still watch for delays. But first of all, we've cleared out through Annandale. You'll hit the volume if you're continuing interloop. Right near the toll road toward the American Legion Bridge, crash into the George Washington Parkway had been cleared. Still some activity, though. DC 295 slows each direction, heading toward East Capitol Street. It's been a long time since we had the earlier crash in the northbound direction gone. And we'll go into Maryland, where crews are still trying to clear a crash in the Columbia area on 175 at Dobbin Road. If you're coming south or eastbound off of 29, still watch for delays, but seeing some slight improvement. Now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Plenty of sunshine today, 97, partly cloudy, 77 overnight.
Traffic and weather brought to you by Media Research Center.
Join me, Chris Plant, Thursday, September 22nd at the Media Research Center's annual gala featuring the hilarious Dishonors Awards. Visit mrc.org/gala. Enter the promo code Chris to get $100 off the ticket price. mrc.org/gala.
If your credit card debt is out of control, if you're in over your head dealing with monthly payments, there's a powerful secret the credit card companies don't want you to know. If you have more than $5,000 in credit card debt, you have the right to settle that debt for a fraction of what you owe. That's bad news for credit card companies, but it's great news for you. We're Credit Associates, and we're offering you free information on how to virtually eliminate your credit card debt and make your monthly payment affordable. To see how much you could save, call now. 1-800-700-3515. Don't declare bankruptcy. Give us 10 minutes and we could save you thousands. We depend on your success and offer a guarantee so there's no risk. Credit Associates. Live better debt-free. Find out how easy it is by calling now. For the secret the credit card companies don't want you to know, call Credit Associates now and see how much money you could save for free. Call 1-800-700-3515. That's 1-800-700-3515.
At the Big Screen Store, Labor Day savings start now. Why not save 50%? Get a huge Samsung 75-inch 4K UHD TV. Originally $49.99, now just $24.99.
Wow! Nothing like watching the big game on a big screen.
The Big Screen Store is the only exclusive Samsung store, and our prices beat Best Buy and warehouse clubs every time.
They even beat Amazon's prices.
And this is huge. We double the length of your Samsung TV warranty free. This week at the Big Screen Store, get a Samsung 65-inch smart LED HD TV for just $8.99.
For Samsung, now that's a great price.
Well, if you're shopping Samsung, the Big Screen Store is the only choice. Just ask our customers.
You've got to check out the Big Screen Store.
Their prices are amazing.
The Big Screen Store.
The Big Screen Store.
The Big Screen Store. Store locations in Maryland and Virginia.
Depression is treatable. At Greenbrook TMS Neuro Health Centers, we understand that often medication and talk therapy just aren't enough. With TMS therapy and FDA-cleared, non-invasive, non-sedating outpatient treatment, there is hope. Accepting most insurances, now including TRICARE and Cigna Healthcare. Treat your depression now. For your free consultation, visit HopeTMS.com. That's HopeTMS.com. Dr. Will Sauvay for Greenbrook TMS Neuro Health Centers.
TMS therapy stands for transcranial magnetic stimulation. It's a treatment that's been FDA indicated for the treatment of depression since 2008. Now with TMS therapy, it is incredible and pretty amazing for me to be able to watch someone get well from depression, see their life change, and see them being able to live their life the way that they always wanted.
To see how TMS therapy can change your life, visit Hope TMS.
Are you putting your money into an IRA, pension, or 401k? Then I hope you're prepared to lose 30, 40, 50% or more of your retirement savings. Because it's not a question of if the market crashes again. It's a question of when. It's going to happen. Did you know there is a way you can protect and grow your wealth safely and predictably every single year? The people using this approach didn't lose a penny when the market crashed in 2000 or 2008, and they won't lose a penny in the next crash. In fact, their money will continue to grow safely year in and year out, even when stocks, real estate, and other investments tumble. A free report detailing this savings program is now available. This free report shows how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and wealth-building power without risking your retirement in the Wall Street casino. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement. It far outperforms any IRA or 401k. To get this free report, visit bankonyourself.com. That's bankonyourself.com. Bankonyourself.com.
How's it going?
I'm having a stroke.
Are you going to shake my hand?
I'm having a stroke.
Wow, you're not even moving your arm.
I'm having a stroke.
When someone is having a stroke, they may not be able to say it with words, but their body language will tell you loud and clear. Look for FAST. F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911 immediately. Know the sudden signs. Spot a stroke fast. Visit strokeassociation.org. Brought to you by the American Stroke Association and the Ad Council.
Two this morning, and I will. And did you see CNN this morning, had on an OBGYN, had out a gynecologist to talk to them about Donald Trump's health. As that shows you what they think of him in this age of gender neutrality. There are a number of words that come to mind, but I can't use them here. Let's go to Sharon in Hyattsville. Sharon, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Good morning, my friend. How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm pretty good, thank you.
I've only got about 2 minutes. You go right ahead.
Okay, I'll try my best. Race is always very important to the Democrats, you know, because that's the only thing they have. That's the only thing they try to win on because they don't have any issues. I'm a woman from the inner city, and I see how the inner city blacks live. That's who Donald Trump is reaching out to. These liberal Democrat elites like Hillary Clinton could care less about inner city blacks unless it's an election year. They did nothing. They do nothing for them. She's been in the office for about 30 years. And the conditions for the inner city blacks get worse and worse every year. So that's the only thing they could go on is try to make people think that Donald Trump is a racist because she don't have anything to offer the blacks. At least inner city black, she does it. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. She don't have a clue.
If you're a billionaire, if you're, Robert Johnson or something, a BET founder, Sheila Johnson, ex-wife, billionaire African-American, then she's got time for you.
Right. Is that right? Only if you have money, you know, or something. But, you know, in the city, she don't. It gets worse. You know, no fathers in the black in the black home. You know, they just the Democrat Party had destroyed the black family, in my opinion. They destroyed it. You know, they think we're lazy. We don't want to work. Only thing we want to do is just sit home and collect welfare and food stamps.
Well, that would be the best thing for the Democrat Party, certainly, because, you know, they have a race-based coalition. That's how they do politics.
WMAL-FM Woodbridge, WMAL Washington.
105.9 FM and AM 630. WMAL Washington. A Cumulus station. Where Washington comes to talk. News. Now,
WMAL News at 10. Good morning, I'm Bill Thompson. In earthquake-stricken central Italy, hope is fading for finding more survivors in a grim race against the clock.
One of the things that's making that race against time that the authorities are in right now even more difficult is the aftershocks that we continue to feel here, especially right here in the epicenter of Amatrice. We had a massive aftershock here in this town. Actually, another building in the town collapsed after that.
Correspondent Frederick Pleitgen, the government of Italy has declared tomorrow a day of national mourning for victims of the earthquake. A Roanoke TV station is marking a sad anniversary today.
We lost our dear friends Allison Parker and Adam Ward. A lot of you were watching at that time. And a year's passed, and there's been some healing, but there will never
days
be
like
complete
this.
Healing ever.
Exactly.
Days like this come.
It just brings it all back.
DBJ TV in Roanoke marked an on-air moment of silence this morning. New this morning, Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe is outlining some of his plans to close the state's more than $1 billion budget shortfall.
McAuliffe says the state can cut more than half of the shortfall in the first year of a two-year budget by doing two things. The first won't come as good news to state workers and teachers.
We will direct $125.1 million from amounts reserved for pay increases in fiscal year 17 toward the shortfall as required by law.
The next?
Using approximately $378.2 million from the Revenue Stabilization Fund.
or rainy day fund. That's something the General Assembly will have to approve. Heather Curtis on WMAL and WMAL.com.
In the face of some conservative criticism, Donald Trump appears to be pivoting again on how to handle illegal immigration. Trump himself articulated his feelings last night, a different stance than he had the night before.
Donald Trump may be reverting to the previous position that all 11 to 12 million undocumented persons in the United States will either be deported or leave voluntarily and can try to go through the legal process. Trump spoke with CNN's Anderson Cooper.
Well, when they come back in, if they come back in, then they can start paying taxes.
So they still have
to leave. But there is no path to legalization unless they leave the country and come back.
Earlier in the week, Trump seemed to change his original position, saying it would be wrong to break up families that had been in the U.S. for years, especially with citizen children born here. Bob Costantini, Washington.
Investors are waiting to hear what Fed Chair Janet Yellen has to say today when she addresses a central bank forum in Wyoming.
Investors have been sitting on the sidelines ahead of Fed Chairwoman Janet Yellen's speech today in Jackson Hole for cues on the timing of an anticipated interest rate hike. A few members of the Fed, citing a strong labor market and other recent upbeat economic signals, have come out in favor of a rate hike sooner rather than later, perhaps as early as the Fed's September meeting. Many analysts say Yellen is unlikely to signal an interest rate hike is coming today, but will likely start preparing the market and complacent investors for an eventual rate hike. I'm Scott Carr on WMAL and WMAL.com.
Some Virginia lawmakers today plan to call on the University of Virginia to explain why it banked over $2 billion while it was raising tuition. Tuition's up 30% since 2013. Checking your money, the Dow right now up 28, the NASDAQ up 7. Up next, traffic and weather on 105.9 FM and AM 630. Washington's Mall, WMAL.
Saturdays on WMAL, hear everything you need to know. Begin your day with 2 hours of the Saturday Morning Update with Rick Fowler, starting at 6. Listen for Garden Sense at 8. At 9, it's Legally Speaking with Mike Collins. At 10, hear Rick Edelman. At noon, catch Investing Sense. At 1, it's Mortgage Radio. At 2, it's Retirement Professor. And at 3 p.m., hear Trading Up. It's everything you need to know on 105.9 FM and AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL.
If you know the value of good machines, then it's high time we got together. We're Bailey Industrial, builders of metal and woodworking equipment, hardworking machines for hardworking people. Because better equipment means better work and getting more done. And keeping you working is what we do best. We stand behind our equipment and make sure our equipment stands behind you, offering you the after-sale support you need to keep your shop running smoothly, which means making sure you have what you need when you need it. Typically shipping within 72 hours or less. So whether you're a hobbyist or a seasoned professional on deadline, go to Bailey.com now and we'll send you a catalog. That's right, friend. Over 400 pages of what you love most. Machines. So whatever you're looking to build, repair, or manufacture, do it with Bailey Industrial, the company you can trust to give you the equipment and service you can rely on. That's B-A-I-L-E-I-G-H. Bailey. Because if it's worth doing right, it's only right to do it with Bailey. So go to Bailey.com now and pick up your free catalog.
To all the men and women that serve our country,
we'd like to thank you for your service.
For all you do to keep us safe.
Thank you for all you do for our country.
Thank you! Brought to you by ARS Rescue Rooter. Thank you.
10:05 at 105.9 FM at AM 630 WMAL. Traffic and weather. Here's Steve Greenfield in the Hadid Carpet Cleaning Traffic
this
Center.
This Friday brings us delays on the inner loop of the Beltway from the Dulles Toll Road to Clara Barton Parkway, plus southbound 295 needs a tap at the brakes, Polk Street to East Capitol Street. Northbound inside the 3rd Street Tunnel down to 10 miles an hour as you head for New York Avenue. Once there, inbound New York Avenue slow, Penn Street to Florida Avenue. In Prince George's County, an accident at the intersection of southbound Laurel Bowie Road and Mile Stream Drive. And in Hyattsville, just one lane gets by for sewer repairs along Cooper Lane between Landing Way and Fairwood Road. In Fairfax County, watch for an accident. The right lane is blocked at Old Chain Bridge Road by Dolly Madison Boulevard. Now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Lots of sunshine, 97 this afternoon, partly cloudy, 77 overnight. Right now, 89 degrees in Washington. I'm Bill Thompson on 105.9 FM at AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL.
Now, Chris Plant. AM 630.
yesterday, Hillary Clinton gave a speech before a largely white audience where she accused Donald Trump of delivering speeches before largely white audiences. Well, we're a largely white country. I suppose you might find largely white audience here and there. These guys are great, aren't they? The Washington Times today has the story. White House struggles to explain how blacks are better off. When did we become this country? This is not the country I grew up in. Thank you, President Obama. Despite government data supporting Donald Trump's claim that blacks are worse off under President Obama, the White House insisted Thursday that blacks have made progress under the first black president and that the Republican nominee would reverse those gains, those important gains. Trump's pitch to black Americans that black Americans have nothing to lose by voting for him is clearly irritating the White House, which tried but failed to muster much convincing evidence that life for blacks in America has improved much over the past 8 years. White House press secretary, the oxymoronically named Josh Earnest, "I think you'd be very hard-pressed to make the case that somehow the African-American population in the United States is somehow not better off," he said. The black unemployment rate in July was 8.4%, but they have a funny way at the Bureau of Labor Statistics these days of counting unemployment, because they don't count people that they say aren't looking for work anymore because people have given up because they can't find jobs because there are no jobs because we have, what is it, 1.2% economic growth? it's rough out there, the economy, as many of us know. 8.4% compared to 12.6% when Mr. Obama took office in January 2009. That was largely a temporary condition. And they stopped counting people that haven't been looking for work for 6 months or more. 6 months or more, no longer counted. They also count you as employed if you have a part-time job, even though you just took the part-time job at McDonald's to keep the lights on because you can't find a full-time job in the field for which you were trained or educated. But the jobless rate for whites, this is it. Why is this election all about race? Oh, because the Democrats want it to be. Because, as Sharon was saying, they don't have a lot that they can point to with pride and say, look at all the great stuff we've done over the last 8 years. The rise of ISIS, terrorist attacks, the terrorists I mentioned earlier, Omar Mateen in Orlando, Hillary supporter. And we should look to see after Election Day whether he showed up and voted for her, even though he's dead. And he's in paradise somewhere with however many raisins he has left, because he might have eaten some of those 72 raisins in the meantime. But the jobless rate for the whites, now at 4.3%, also fiction, for the same reasons, has fallen slightly more than it has for blacks in the last 8 years, down 37% for whites, down 33% for blacks, both numbers largely fictional. That is my editorial addition to the story. On a range of other government data, blacks are faring worse under Mr. Obama. Can I say Ms. Obama? Would that be, because in this age of gender fluidity, I wouldn't want to pigeonhole him in any way, neither would Larry Sinclair. The black labor force participation rate has fallen from 63.2% in 2009 to 61.2% last month. That is down 3.1%. So the labor participation number also indicates that those people are not being counted as unemployed because they're no longer in the labor force, largely because they can't find jobs. Black home ownership last month was 41.7%, down from 46.1% in 2009, a drop of nearly 10%, this says, although it looks more like 6% to me. The percentage of black Americans living below the poverty line has risen from 25.8% in 2009 to 26.2%. 2014, it is an uptick, but that's not movement in the right direction. according to the most recent Census Bureau data. The number of African-American food stamp recipients spiked from 7.3 million to 11.7 million, an increase of 58% number of African-Americans on food stamps. Confronted by such statistics, the White House said Thursday, it's important for Hillary Clinton to build on Mr. Obama's legacy. Well, with accomplishments like that, you can hardly blame them for preening with pride. The president never made the case that the work is finished, that the job is done, Josh Earnest said yesterday. The job is never done. They're government. If you're black, they're never done with you. The point is, Earnest said, President Obama's interested in being succeeded in office by someone who is committed to building on the progress we've made thus far, as opposed to tearing it down. Well, such progress, I mean, the number of people on food stamps and the home ownership declining and the number of people participating in the labor force declining for African Americans, it's just good news all around. Everything's coming up roses from what I can see. And also, I love what Bob the Liberal, there with the old Strom Thurmond versus Robert Byrd thing. That's a classic saw that the Democrats trot out every time. And they, of the Howard Zinn wing of American politics, love the scars, the blights of slavery and Jim Crow in the United States. And they can never be forgotten. They can never be forgiven. They're not the past. They're not prologue. That is a stain on our history. But when it comes to the Democrat Party, well, he apologized. So there you go. He apologized. So you just move on. That's apologize. It's Monty Python-esque. And the other guy, he became Strom Thurmond. He became Strom Thurmond, who in his 40s landed behind enemy lines on June 5th, 1944 in France on a glide plane. Too old to be drafted, he enlisted. He went special forces, pointy end of the spear, landing behind German lines the day before the Normandy invasion. And he's got some pretty good stuff on his resume, too. And he did stop being a racist when he left the Democrat Party. So, you know, setting that aside for the moment. Let me go, if we could. Let's go. Here's Hillary Clinton's speech in a nutshell from yesterday. This alt-right thing is a new kind of fabrication of the left. And now, left-wing extremists, this alt-right, Breitbart, these terrible people, they're awful, they're white supremacists, and they paint with a broad brush, let's say, to be generous. But they smear, they slander, they slime, rinse, repeat. That's what they do. They're the Democrat Party. They don't have anything to point to with pride, so they smear. It's what the Clintons have always done. The Clintons have, during the Bill Clinton years, the economy was good. Newt Gingrich was the Speaker of the House, got the budget in order, inherited 12 years of Reagan-Bush economic policies. The Cold War was over. You know, life was looking pretty good for the United States of America when Clinton took office, which why he could chase the chubby interns around the Resolute desk in the Oval Office and do things that we can't even speak of here. I was talking about this last night with someone, though. The Resolute desk in the Oval Office, it's been there for generations now. And we know, based on Monica Lewinsky's account, testimony in court, Ken Starr investigation, all that good stuff, we know that Bill Clinton used that desk for a variety of things involving Monica Lewinsky and sitting on the edge of the desk and the propping up and the this and the that and all over the desk and don't go through there with a black light. And we know that. And that would be, if she's elected, that would be Hillary Clinton's desk. It's a Shakespearean kind of hell. Whatever, don't smell the desk. Jeez. But that would be Hillary Clinton's desk, the desk that we know her husband was cavorting, I'll euphemize and say cavorting, with the interns and who knows who else. It was like Vegas Casino with Fredo Corleone in charge when Bill Clinton was in the Oval Office. Hillary Clinton's speech from yesterday in a nutshell.
Donald Trump has built his campaign on prejudice and paranoia. Largely white audiences, insulting and ignorant racial discrimination. Racist lie. Racist comment. Textbook definition of a racist comment. White supremacist, fringe bigot, white supremacist, white nationalist leader, racist undertones. Prejudice, racial divides, hate groups. These are racist ideas, race-baiting ideas, anti-Muslim, anti-immigrant, anti-women, white identity, racial resentment, one white supremacist said. Racist white supremacist, the hate burns just as bright. Make America hate
burns.
Again.
There's
white
a staff
students
for
held
that.
Up Trump signs, stirring up this bigotry and prejudice. Stand up against prejudice.
Now cut to the picture of her at Donald Trump's wedding, shall we? Now, show the checks cashed by Hillary Clinton when she was running for Senate, or by the Clinton Foundation, because Donald Trump generously donated to her cause. If we're going to do guilt by association, then if Hillary Clinton were a Republican, she'd be a racist just for going to Donald Trump's wedding, based on the way that she described, by using her own yardstick, using her own metric here. Donald Trump yesterday went out and preempted. They gave a speech before Hillary Clinton's speech, because we all knew, they told the media what it was going to... Oh, we're going to talk about jobs. No, we're not. We're going to talk about... we're going to call everybody racist. And if you support them, you're a white supremacist and you're a racist. And that's what it's all about. They just want to make it all about polarization. It's the Saul Alinsky playbook. She worked for Saul Alinsky in college. She wrote her thesis paper about Saul Alinsky. She's an Alinskyite to the core. Barack Obama's an Alinskyite. Radical left playbook. Calls for the polarization of populations along lines of race, class, gender, sexual preference, any other way you can find, but race in particular. Get some race riots going. We played the audio for you last week from Milwaukee, where Hillary supporters, African Americans, 91% Hillary supporters, according to all the polls, shouting, get that, he's white, get him. And did you see the gang of black people beating up a white guy, a white reporter, a couple of days ago? And somebody had to intervene and stop him from beating up the white gang of black people, because the guy's yelling, I'm Asian. The guy they're beating up, he's a reporter, and he's getting beat up by a bunch of black people. And they're like, oh wait, he's Asian. Oh, sorry, we thought you were white. There we go. That's Barack Obama's America. Donald Trump yesterday before Hillary Clinton's speech.
It's a movement, folks, like they've never seen before. And going to accuse decent Americans who support this campaign, your campaign, of being racists, which we're not.
Which we're not.
It's the oldest play in the Democratic playbook. When Democratic policies fail, they are left with only this one tired argument. You're racist, you're racist, you're racist. They keep saying it. You're racist.
We used to be the party of racism, but now we're the party of good. We're the party of not racism. And remember the party of Lincoln and of getting the Civil Rights Act passed and the Voting Rights Act passed? They're the racist now. You know why? Because Strom Thurmond was a Democrat. Then he became a Republican. There it is, ipso facto. There you got it. You got it right there. Yeah. Barack Obama's America. He's made some... so much progress, so many strides forward. Yep. Yeah, Politico reporter being beat up at a Black Lives Matter protest, but they're not a hate group and they're not racist. Politico reporter in Milwaukee being beat up by a violent mob of racists, but it's not in the news. They stopped because he was Asian, and they really, their only way of beating Whitey that day. Fundamental transformation.
You're listening to The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
If your friend at work told you she just found a way to save half on her dry cleaning every week, would you switch to that dry cleaner?
What if all your friends told you that they found a great new dry cleaner that charges half what most full-price cleaners charge? Then would you switch? Well, what if I told you that a million people had dumped their full-price cleaners for Zips dry cleaners? Would that convince you to at least try us? Because that's how many people have switched to Zips, where we charge a flat $2.29 to dry clean any garment, and even less to launder shirts. Zips uses an efficient, state-of-the-art process to clean your clothes. It's just that we charge you way less to do it. Zips has truly revolutionized the dry cleaning business, one $2.29 garment at a time. So bring in the load of clothes you normally take to the full-price cleaners and see for yourself just how smart it is to use Zips. A million people wearing clean clothes can't be wrong. Come to Zips. Professional cleaning, unbeatable pricing. For a Zips near you, visit 321zips.com.
Hey, it's Larry O'Connor, and it's awesome recommending my friends, Realtors Sarah and Debbie Reynolds of the Reynolds Team with Keller Williams. And congratulations to the Reynolds Team for being named for the fourth year in a row one of the top teams in Virginia by the Wall Street Journal. Listen, this is critical. Don't just hire any agent or one that claims to be an area specialist when really they have minimal reach and risk losing thousands and wasted time having your home shown to tire kickers. You know what I mean? Get Sarah and Debbie's proven home selling systems working for you instead. They're so confident they'll sell your home that if it doesn't sell, they will buy it at a price acceptable to you. Call Sarah and Debbie Reynolds today. Start packing tomorrow. 844-344-SOLD. That's 844-344-SOLD. If you want top dollar in a fast sale, call the only agents I would call to make this happen and the only ones I would trust to sell my home. The Reynolds Team. 844-344-SOLD. That's 844-344-SOLD. Or visit DebbieHasTheBuyers.com. That's DebbieHasTheBuyers.com and start packing today.
Want to know the secret that those flipping houses gurus won't tell you? Is that flipping multi-unit properties is easier and more profitable than flipping single-family homes. With over 17 years of experience, we here at RE Mentor will show you the art of buying and selling multi-unit properties. Come spend the afternoon or evening with our team of experts, and we will show you how to put $10,000 to $30,000 in your pocket over the next 90 days. This two-hour class will teach you the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. You'll learn how to buy, hold, and sell multi-unit properties with no money down, no credit, and no risk. You risk nothing but have everything to gain. This intensive two-hour real estate class is coming to the DMV area soon. Call 1-800-863-7614 to secure your seat now. This seminar is free for the first 30 people that call. Change your life now and learn the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. Call 1-800-863-7614. 1-800-863-7614. Call now.
When towers seem like trees and roads become rivers, the Range Rover Evoque is there to guide you through the twists and turns of the urban jungle. Gaze up through the available full-glass panoramic roof to take in the city from an unexpected angle. Lease the 2016 Range Rover Evoque SE Premium 5-door for $379 per month for 33 months with $1,000 summer credit included in lease payments and $39.95 plus taxes, title, and fees due at signing now through September 30th. Visit your local D.C. area Land Rover retailer or call 1-800-FIND-4WD for details. Land Rover, above and beyond.
Coming to the Event Center at Hollywood Casino. Legendary acts like Jeff Foxworthy, Kenny Rogers, Buddy Guy, Chris D'Elia, and Tony Braxton. The biggest names in entertainment always find a way back to Hollywood. Visit Ticketmaster.com today. Only at Hollywood Casino at Charlestown Races. All gaming is regulated by the West Virginia Lottery. Gamble too much? Call 1-800-522-4700 for free confidential help.
Hi, Rick Edelman here. You need a financial plan, and you know we've provided personal financial plans to thousands of people just like you. We normally charge $800 for a financial plan, but here's a way you can get yours for just $20 a month over 12 months. Just tune in to my new PBS television special on WETA and Maryland Public Television. My new special will show you how to manage your investments, get the most from Social Security, and help you choose the right beneficiaries. And you can get your personal financial plan from an Edelman financial planner when you make a pledge of just $240 or just $20 a month for 12 months to PBS. It's our gift to you for supporting your local PBS station. Go to rickedelman.com for details and airtimes. That's ricedelman.com. And thank you for supporting public television.
Advisory services offered through Edelman Financial Services, LLC. Securities offered through EF Legacy Securities, LLC, an affiliated broker-dealer. Member FINRA, SIPC.
So which party's policies really help African Americans and minorities? We'll talk about it today on Washington's Drive at 5.
Get into this. He wasn't actually an employed reporter employed with the Politico, but he wrote the piece in the Politico about being attacked and beaten by a violent racist mob. I notice he hasn't been in. This was in Milwaukee during the racial unrest there. Thank you, President Obama. Because a black police officer shot a black guy that had a gun in his hand, a gun that he stole from a home, and when he was running from the police. And so apparently, he should let everybody go, and then the murder rate should skyrocket like it did in Baltimore last year, and then liberals will be happy again. Let's go to Kevin in Rockville. Kevin, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Hey, Chris, how you doing?
Very well, Kevin. Thank you.
Listen, I'm calling in response to the guy that was arguing with you about not needing an ID, and I have two anecdotal evidence of how imperative that it is.
Could you talk a little more directly into the phone? I think you tucked it under your chin, didn't you?
Sure. Is that better?
Yeah, a little better. Go ahead.
Okay. The first is, at the last presidential election, I went to vote, and I'm standing in line, and this woman who was about 28, 29 years old, by the way, I'm 56.
Uh-huh.
This woman is 28, 29 years old in front of me, registers at the desk to go vote in my mother's name. Uses my mother's address, my mother's name. My mother had been dead at that point for about 10 years.
Really?
When I spoke up and said, hey, that's not my mother. My mother is dead. My mother can't vote. The election officials started to talk to me and ushered me out of the voting office, the voting hall, and refused to allow me to vote, even though I had a legal ID and I had a legal right to vote.
A woman in front of you used your mother's name and your mother's address
to vote.
You know, I work a colleague here at the radio station, a woman who's in sales, who lived in Chicago for a number of years doing sales at radio in Chicago, registered to vote there, voted there, moved to Boston for several years, and after several years in Boston, where she registered to vote and voted, moved back to Chicago, went to register to vote again, and discovered that she had been voting in Chicago the whole time she was gone.
Yeah, I can imagine in Chicago that was probably very prevalent.
She's like, well, I haven't lived here for the last 6 years. Like, well, you've been voting.
It's amazing. It is amazing how prevalent voter fraud is in this country.
Well, and the idea, you know, the news media doesn't look out for it. They pretend that it doesn't exist because their party tells them that it doesn't exist. And to pretend that any operation this big goes off flawlessly without a single example of voter fraud is comical on its face. But we're expected to believe it because the Democrat Party says so, and it's parroted by the news media. And somehow it's racist to suggest that a person should be expected to have a driver's license in America, which is pretty funny. Try to do anything. I mean, if you don't have a driver's license, some kind of photo ID, then you must live in a cardboard box on a sidewalk in front of an abandoned building on a skid row somewhere, which, of course, makes you a Democrat voter.
This is the Chris Plant Show. WMAL-FM Woodbridge, WMAL Washington. 105.9 FM and AM 630. WMAL Washington. A Cumulus station. Where Washington comes to talk. News. Now.
WMAL News at 10:30. Good morning. I'm Bill Thompson. Strong aftershocks have been rattling central Italy again today and have shut down a key route into the hard-hit town of Amatrice. The mayor says aftershock damage to the roads is threatening to isolate his town. Hillary Clinton is defending the work of her family foundation and says if elected, she will take additional steps to make sure there are no conflicts of interest between her administration and the Clinton Foundation. The government reports the U.S. economy expanded at a sluggish pace this spring as businesses sharply reduced their stockpiles stockpiles of goods and spent less on new buildings and equipment. But with the economy improving, Fed Chair Janet Yellen says this morning she foresees an interest rate hike ahead, offered no timetable, though. Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe is warning state lawmakers to brace for tough decisions ahead to address a roughly $1.5 billion budget shortfall. Dozens of Baltimore County schools that don't have air conditioning don't have classes today. The Baltimore County School Board ordered those 37 non-air-conditioned schools must close whenever the heat index is forecast to reach 90 by 11 a.m. Checking your money, the Dow right now up 106, the Nasdaq up 38. WMAL traffic and weather. Here's Steve Greenfield in the Hadid Carpet Cleaning Traffic Center.
Adding to your typical mid-morning delays, northbound I-95 in Maryland has road work just past Route 198. The left lane is blocked. Plus, in the southeast, there's an accident. Police on scene at Massachusetts Avenue near the Randall Circle. In Prince George's County, Cooper's Lane has water and sewer repairs. Just one lane gets by between Landing Way and Fairwood Road. And in Fort Washington, southbound Indian Head Highway with construction, the right lane blocked by Livingston Road. All other incidents in my last report have now cleared. Now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Lots of sunshine today, the high 97, partly cloudy 77 overnight. Sunny and 94 tomorrow, Sunday, sunshine 93. Right now, 88 in Centerville, 86 in Silver Spring, 89 in Washington. I'm Bill Thompson on 105.9 FM at AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL.
1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS, K-A-R-S, Cars for Kids. 1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS, donate your car today. 1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS, K-A-R-S, Cars for Kids. 1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS, donate your car today.
To learn more about our programs and to donate, visit us online at carsforkids.com. Remember, that's Cars with a K. Pickup is quick and easy. You'll also get a vacation voucher and maximum tax deduction.
1-877-CARS-FOR-KIDS. Also accepting boats, motorcycles, RVs, and real estate donations.
If you know the value of good machines, then it's high time we got together. We're Bailey Industrial, builders of metal and woodworking equipment, hardworking machines for hardworking people. Because better equipment means better work and getting more done. And keeping you working is what we do best. We stand behind our equipment and make sure our equipment stands behind you. Offering you the after-sale support you need to keep your shop running smoothly, which means making sure you have what you need when you need it. Typically shipping within 72 hours or less. So whether you're a hobbyist or a seasoned professional on deadline, go to Bailey.com now and we'll send you a catalog. That's right, friend. Over 400 pages of what you love most, machines. So whatever you're looking to build, repair, or manufacture, do it with Bailey Industrial, the company you can trust to give you the equipment and service you can rely on. That's B-A-I-L-E-I-G-H. Bailey. Because if it's worth doing right, it's only right to do it with Bailey. So go to Bailey.com now and pick up your free catalog.
Here's a quiz. Is identity theft just when someone other than you puts charges on your credit card? Nope, that's part of it. But identity theft is actually when someone pretends they're you for any number of undesirable reasons, like opening new accounts or a utility bill. Is it true that identity theft can't happen to you? Nope. 1 in 4 people have experienced identity theft. Will LifeLock help you more with identity theft than free credit monitoring will? Yep. LifeLock's proprietary technology detects a huge range of identity threats. And if you ever have a problem, one of our U.S.-based agents will work to resolve it. So how'd you do on the quiz? Come on, how'd you really do? No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses. But with LifeLock, you get a versus a when it comes to identity protection. Membership starts at just $9.99 a month plus applicable taxes. Go to LifeLock.com and enter promo code NEWS to get 10% off now. LifeLock.
105.9 FM and AM 630. Washington's Mall. WMAL. Where Washington comes to talk.
Barack Barack Obama's America, Hillary Clinton's America, the Democrat Party's America. When's the last time the Democrats didn't control Milwaukee? It was 1906 or something like that. It's some crazy period of time ago. Here's a story from the Politico. It's a little left-wing blog site here in Washington, D.C. But they had a guy from Milwaukee type up a piece for him. The headline is, "You're Asian, right? Why are you even here?" That's the headline. It's in quotation marks. "What I learned when I was attacked and spared because of my race at a Black Lives Matter protest." This has gone completely and utterly unnoticed by the so-called news media. Milwaukee is the dateline, and this is a young guy. He's Chinese-American. He was an intern for, I think his internship is finished now, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, or the Milwaukee Urinal Sentinel, as they call it there. And he was sent out to cover protests, along with another intern who is a young man who's Caucasian, poor him. And they went to cover the Black Lives Matter protest after a guy with a gun was shot by a black police officer and killed, which is a good way to get killed, just by the way. "I knew the protest was going to spiral into something bigger when I saw a man in tears push a police officer. I had never seen anyone lay a hand on a cop, even amicably. But these people gathered now in the street were utterly out of patience. Say they lost patience because a criminal with a long criminal record who had stolen a gun from someone's home evaded the police, running down the street, pointing the gun back at the police, and a black police officer shoots him. You could see why you'd run out of patience for such things. I wasn't sure whether I'd be caught in the crossfire. Then a community activist," he uses the term community activist. This guy's going to make a great reporter, just wait till you hear what this going to. "A community activist I had earlier asked to interview spotted me and called me over. He said, 'I can see from your face you don't think you're safe,' he told me. He was black. 'I'm Chinese American.' 'You are,' he said. 'You're a minority too.'" Oh, okay, well, establish your Klan racist bona fides here, your credentials. "You're a racist, son. You're a horrible, violent Klansman. Choose your enemies well, it has been said, because they're the ones you become most like." It's a great old saying, and it applies here. "I was sent out to go report on the scene as an intern for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, my last assignment for the summer," he writes. "I was the only non-black person there at the time. The other news crews had left, and my presence was soon questioned. Someone pointed me out as an interloper. Others, like the reassuring activist, told me I would be fine. I brushed off the more hostile comments as much as I could. They were angry, and anger doesn't always hit its intended target." He's making excuses for the violent mob in the street. "As the confrontation went on, the crowd became more and more violent. What started as shoving and rock throwing escalated into smashing cars and setting businesses aflame." Aflame, he uses the word aflame. "By nightfall, I was crouching behind a Chevy Suburban to avoid bullets. I assume behind the police line so braver men than yourself could stand up to protect you and the rest of the community. Another intern, a white man," everything's about race, "who had arrived later on to take photos, huddled beside me. After the gunfire ceased, he emerged from behind the car to take more pictures while I stayed behind. I guess he's braver than you. 'Get your white ass out of here,' he soon heard. 'You better not let me, expletive deleted, catch you,' another person yelled. After trying unsuccessfully to defuse the situation," that is, talk his way out of it, "'my colleague,'" his white colleague, "'was flying down the street with a group of men chasing him.'" He's the white guy who's a mob of violent black racists chasing him. But this is okay. Now, if you reverse this, this is huge national news. The network anchors are still in Milwaukee out on the street talking about this, wired to a satellite truck. "Wanting to help, but not knowing how, I decided to run after them. In order to run faster, my colleague dropped the two bulky cameras hanging around his neck." I guess they belong to the newspaper. "When I tried to retrieve them and yelled at him to get out of the area..." Thanks for the helpful hint there. Get out of here! Get out of here! Yeah, that's kind of my idea. That's why I'm running real fast and dropped the big cameras. You may have noticed. Some in the group of rioters started chasing after me, too. How dare they? As a former back-of-the-pack runner in middle school gym class, I wasn't surprised when they caught me. He wasn't surprised when, because he's Chinese and he's middle of the pack and they're black. I think that's a racist stereotype that he's peddling here. Naturally, the black people caught him. What, they're all Usain Bolt. You know, that's the Chinese guy's take on it. When they threw me to the ground, he just skips ahead, they caught me. When they threw me to the ground, I reflexively curled up into a ball. Blows landed on my back, my head, my torso. Stop, someone yelled. He's not white. He's Asian. See how this goes? This is Barack Obama's. This is Hillary Clinton's America. I wasn't sure who said it or how they knew my race, but within seconds, the punches stopped. This is good stuff, isn't it? Dramatic reading, too, I think, as well, isn't it? Someone grabbed me by the arm and lifted me up. My vision came back into focus. I saw a group of concerned black faces and heard someone repeating, "Don't expletive deleted with the Chinese dudes." I'll clean it up. "Don't mess with the Chinese dudes." It's probably fear of the tongs, don't you think? Fear of the Chinese street gangs. Fear of the heroin trade. Fear of maybe karate. Maybe I guess they'd already established that he wasn't karate man, since he's crouching on the ground and huddling into an egg shape. Assuming the fetal position is not a karate move. Last time I looked, but there it is. And that's now. Has this guy been invited on CNN to tell his tale of woe again and again? No. No, he hasn't. No, he most certainly has not. Aaron Mack is the forgotten Chinese guy. He's a Chinese-American. And see, they were only out to get white people, as that audio that I played at the beginning. And this is what Hillary Clinton is contributing to. And this is what Barack Obama is contributing to. Now, the last time we saw a gang of white supremacists out in the street chasing black people down, it was a gang of Democrats led by Sheriff Bull Connor, the Democrat. And it was decades, generations ago. I'm not aware of this happening any place in modern times with, and if it had, I can assure you it'd be a big story. I guess I can think, what was his name? James Byrd in Texas. Terrible, horrible, white, racist people murdered James Byrd. And it was a huge national story, and I still remember his name. And it was decades ago. And it was a horrible murder. It was a murder. This kind of stuff is just a Democrat Party backyard barbecue, really. This is what Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton, and the Democrats have done to race in America. This wasn't happening during George W. Bush. And it's not because several black people were shot by cops. The cops killed twice as many white people as they kill black people. Black police officers are more likely to shoot black suspects than white police officers, our statistics show. So this is about community organizers. It's about Barack Obama and Van Jones and DeRay McKesson. It's about Black Lives Matter. This was it's described right here as a Black Lives Matter event. Black Lives Matter, white lives definitely don't. So there we've got that going for us. God bless America. Thank you, President Obama. You're such a wonderful leader. These guys are so good. And yesterday's speech was all about white supremacists and saying, not implying directly, but out and out saying that Donald Trump, whose wedding Hillary Clinton attended, is an out and out white supremacist, racist, good as the KKK. They put this TV ad out yesterday also, which is just over the top. And you've got to hear this one with, it's David Duke. And, I mean, again, David Duke said something nice about Donald Trump. He did. But Omar Mateen, the Pulse nightclub Orlando mass murdering jihadi, said nice things about Hillary Clinton. So we've got this kind of dichotomy. And the Democrats, the press that they control, bang one drum while completely avoiding the other. Black Lives Matter. Communist Party USA endorsing Hillary Clinton. Communists have only murdered 100 million people in the last year, and they stole all their stuff, too. I don't know why that would be a problem. Jeremiah Wright, the Jews won't let me meet with Barack Obama. That's all okay. That's no big deal. That's not a thing. That's all okay. All right, let me go to the telephones. Let's go to Angela in Montclair. Angela, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Hey, Chris, thank you for taking my call.
You bet.
You know, it's funny how the more things change, the more they stay the same.
Mm.
Now, Hillary Clinton was complaining yesterday that Donald Trump talked about the black community in the most despicable ways. And I know I've called your program and said that, you know, the way that President Obama and the Democrats deal with black people is always, you know, in a low-down way, talking about their program crumbs. Their constant mantra has always been income inequality, poor failing schools, black male unemployment, high incarceration. This is how they would describe the black community. And having done in these communities where there is income inequality, and poor and failing schools and high black unemployment, mm-hmm. The Democrat Party has been, and what Donald Trump was pointing out, they've been the one running these communities and haven't done anything about it. And so whenever he points it out, Hillary Clinton had the audacity to stand there and act indignant, like she just could hardly believe that he would talk about the black community in the way that they have always talked about the black community.
And people, and how you might get shot walking down the street in Chicago or Detroit or Baltimore. Baltimore shattering its all-time per capita homicide rate last year. Chicago is an absolute disgrace.
It is a disgrace. And the truth of the matter is, during the presidential elections, they never addressed those realities in those communities, and then have the audacity to be upset whenever Donald Trump mentions it. Like he has no right to say anything about it. Like, you know, the black community is their little kids, their children. You don't say anything about the black community. You're not allowed to. And it's so unfortunate that so many people in some of the inner cities and in the black community buy into it. But I think Donald Trump is doing it the right way and talking with the leadership of those communities, because the way that it's worked and the Democrats have figured this out a long time ago. You address their leadership, and the leadership addresses the communities.
There are, of course, more poor white people in the United States of America because there are more white people than there are poor black people. But I don't hear anybody making a case for poor white people living below the poverty line, white people on food stamps.
Because you know the reason why that is, because white people, it just the white people are not considered a voting bloc. Now, they will divide within the white community as far as women and as far as gun owners or soccer moms. They will try to divide that way. But they can lump every black person together, every single black person together, and that's exactly what they do. So that's the reason why they don't just come out and talk to the white community or white people in that fashion. And it's, I think the whole thing is just unfortunate. People are individuals, and we live individual lives, and to pretend like it's anything different, you know, that's just, the Democrats have been treating black people bad from the very beginning. And that first caller that you had, the Democrat, he's the type of liberal that disgusts me, to talk down to me and to pretend like we're some pitiful, like I'm some pitiful person, or everybody black is some pitiful person that needs his sympathy, which we do not. And that is the whole that's the frustration for me.
He's the great white father.
Exactly.
He's a great white father in Washington, D.C. And here's that. I've talked about this before, Angela, also, that if you, and it doesn't matter, just eliminate race, which used to be the idea of the United States of America. Eliminate race. If you're dependent on the government, your life stinks.
Exactly.
And if you're self-reliant, your life is much better. That's a pretty straightforward proposition that's not taught by Democrats to anybody, and certainly not to African-Americans in the United States of America. Again, there are more poor white people.
It's the black leadership, Chris. These are the things now. It's this constant, I'm talking to a family member, and it's this constant idea that we have to fix things in the black community that have already, you know, they talk about slavery like it still exists.
Right.
Like we were slaves. And it's like, you were never a slave and neither were I, was I. I'm 52 years old and I don't remember the black only or white only and signs or anything like that. The United States have moved far, far away from that reality. And, they want to pretend that that has not happened, and people do what they want to do. People take vacations, they get married, they give into marriage, people do exactly what they want to do. But, you know, you have the Democrat Party and the black leadership preaching this whole idea that things have not been resolved and they still need to fight the same old
right.
fight.
Right.
And, you know,
and,
my mom,
and again, it's because they have nothing else. And I believe that this
they have nothing else.
The last 8 years have set back this country by two generations.
It has. Chris, that is just the absolute truth. But I will say this. My mother, she's in her 70s, and she said to me in a whispering kind of tone, we were discussing something about the presidential race, and one of my daughters mentioned whatever. But she said in sort of a quiet tone, as if she didn't want anybody else to hear her say, a lot of this stuff we're arguing about, it's already been settled. I think we just really need to just move on and focus on the future. And she, you know, a lot of people don't want to hear that truth. They just don't want to hear, like, you know, we're not, we don't have segregated water fountains, but if you continue with the college students, they probably will eventually have.
Well, that's exactly right. You got black college students on campuses all over America demanding separate but equal accommodations. And I've been reading the stories lately of the which campus was it where they had the black housing, and the black students are people of color only need apply. No white people need apply. And they're racist. These people in the street in Milwaukee hunting down white people and saying, stop beating him up, he's Asian. They're racists. Kids who were being raised today before Barack Obama were being raised in a much less racist and racially polarized country when George W. Bush was president than they are now. This was in the rearview mirror. If you're 20 today, I'd like to apologize for everything that the Democrats have done, because when you were 10, the country was a much better place on matters of race. But this is what the Democrats have done to us. We've got racist attacks, racist mobs, black lives matter, white lives don't. Open borders, and it's all for the benefit of the Democrat Party. Period. Full stop. That's all there is to it. There is a body count associated with it. Start with the police officers in Dallas and go from there. Angela, thank you.
There's only one Chris Plant. The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall. WMAL. Where Washington comes to talk. Here's a quiz. Is identity theft just when someone other than you puts charges on your credit card? Nope, that's part of it. But identity theft is actually when someone pretends they're you for any number of undesirable reasons, like opening new accounts or a utility bill. Is it true that identity theft can't happen to you? Nope. 1 in 4 people have experienced identity theft. Will LifeLock help you more with identity theft than free credit monitoring will? Yep. LifeLock's proprietary technology detects a huge range of identity threats. And if you ever have a problem, one of our U.S.-based agents will work to resolve it. So how'd you do on the quiz? Come on, how'd you really do? No one can prevent all identity theft or monitor all transactions at all businesses. But with LifeLock, you get a versus a when it comes to identity protection. Membership starts at just $9.99 a month plus applicable taxes. Go to LifeLock.com and enter promo code LifeLock to get 10% off now. LifeLock.
This is Brian Scudamore. You hear me on the radio sometimes.
And we're his main man, Tom.
We believe your complete happiness is rooted in 4 basic freedoms.
Number 1,
freedom from hunger.
We believe everyone should have enough to eat.
Number 2,
freedom from fear. We believe everyone deserves to live in peace.
Number 3,
freedom from external limitations. We believe everyone should have unlimited opportunity.
Number 4,
freedom from junk. We believe pointless stuff will stifle your spirit.
1-800-GOT-JUNK can give you wings
so you can escape from pointless things
and begin to live without those strings
joyfully like queens and kings.
We work until midnight 7 days a week
so you never have to take off work to meet us.
Set yourself free today. Call 1-800-GOT-JUNK
or visit 1-800-GOT-JUNK.com.
Hiring people is probably the worst part of my job. It's such a hassle, the searching, the sorting through resumes. Most people don't have the right experience.
We started using ZipRecruiter about 3 months ago. Right from the start, you could tell it was going to make hiring a lot easier. One click and my job was posted to 100 plus job boards, all the top sites.
All of the candidates came to my dashboard, and it's easy to compare them. Thumbs up if I liked them, thumbs down if I didn't. No emails and attachments, printing up docs, phone calls, none of that.
And I couldn't believe the number of great applicants we got. I had the person we needed within 1 week. I don't know how we hired before ZipRecruiter.
Whether you're looking to fill one position or 20, find the best candidates with ZipRecruiter, where your job is just one click away from 100-plus job sites. ZipRecruiter, the fastest way to hire. And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/work. That's ZipRecruiter.com/work. ZipRecruiter.com/work.
Hi, I'm Dr. Alex McMillan of McMillan Sedation Dentistry, and I've seen people's daily lives interrupted by chronic mouth pain, missing teeth, and slipping dentures. Dental implants are a permanent solution that we offer in a single pain-free visit using nationally recognized state-of-the-art technology. Your new smile will look and feel completely natural. Why consider dental implants? Because losing one or more of your teeth creates a gap in your smile, affects your ability to chew properly, and causes the appearance of premature aging. The dental implant treatments I use are designed in a lab by highly skilled artisans with the latest materials and technology. Smile big. Eat what you want. With over 35 years of experience, advanced training and certification in the very latest techniques, I can provide a brand new, beautiful smile in a single, pain-free visit. Call 877-394-4511. Online at smileeasy.com. That's smileeasy.com.
It's panic time. The boss just asked you when that new building will be completed, and you haven't even started yet. Well, don't panic. Call the name you know, General Steel. You've known General Steel for decades, and you know they'll save you about half the cost and about half the time of conventional construction. But did you know that General Steel has provided buildings for some of the biggest names in business and government? And did you know that General can provide pre-construction planning services for your total project? And I'll bet you didn't know you can get General Steel quality and save thousands. For example, a 40-foot by 60-foot building for under $22,000, or a 50 by 100 for under $35,000. That's right, 5,000 square feet for under $35,000. And all with General Steel's 50-year structural warranty. So don't panic. Call now and lock in some of the lowest prices this year. 866-96-STEEL. Call 866-96-STEEL today. Quick, the boss is coming. That's 866-967-8335.
105.9 FM and AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
I have funny audio and tragic audio and nutty audio and Mika Brzezinski audio and all kinds of audio coming up. In the next hour, having to do with all of this, hey, Barack Obama's America, let's have a race riot. What if you threw a race riot and nobody came? I like concealed carry. Oh, I really don't have... I didn't give myself a lot of time to... Let's go to Bruce in Prince Frederick. Bruce, I'm almost out of time, but I wanted to jump to you.
Hey, Chris, 32-year veteran. Thank you for what you're doing. I just have one comment I wanted to see what your thoughts were. You know, we have two generations in school now not being taught that there's absolute truth and evil. And I think that sets people up for just going for the kind of propaganda that you see politically now, because they don't know how to sort out and get down to what's reality.
I think that's 100% true. And let's look at the teachers' unions. I played audio from them talking about Marx.
WMAL-FM Woodbridge, WMAL Washington. 105.9 FM and AM 630, WMAL Washington. A Cumulus station, where Washington comes to talk. News.
Now. WML News at 11. Good morning, I'm Bill Thompson. International rescue crews are still looking for earthquake survivors in central Italy, but the hopes of finding any are growing dim.
They know it's a race against the clock, and I have to say, in the past couple of hours, they really haven't found any survivors that we've seen, and really have only been able to pull dead bodies from the rubble, but that doesn't mean that they're giving up. They say, you know, they've done the past couple of days, they've done throughout the entire night, and they're going to stay here until they're absolutely sure that there is no one still buried underneath that rubble.
Correspondent Frederick Pleitgen. Federal Reserve Chair Janet Yellen says the Fed is moving toward raising interest rates again in light of a solid job market and an improving outlook for the economy. But this morning, she stopped short of signaling any particular timetable for the next rate hike. Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe is warning Virginia lawmakers to brace for some difficult choices in coming months to address a roughly $1.5 billion budget shortfall.
We must prepare ourselves for tough decisions ahead. Once we have a firm grasp on required actions for fiscal year 2017, by early October, we will tackle remaining issues with the 2018 budget year. Coach Vince Lombardi once said, "Winners never quit, and quitters never win." We began this administration with a goal to build a new Virginia economy, and we plan to get there.
The governor spoke this morning to the General Assembly's money committees. McAuliffe says Virginia's budget problems are being driven by lower income and sales tax revenue collections than had been anticipated. The Maryland State Fair is underway.
It's one of those things that signals the end of summer in our area, the rides and attractions at the Maryland State Fair. And while the event is based on tradition, the fair's Edie Bernier says there are new attractions, among them a therapeutic horse exhibit.
We have Horses Healing Maryland's Military Riding Showcase. It's a program, therapeutic program that helps veterans along with the U.S. Army Caisson Platoon.
The fair, located in Timonium, runs through Labor Day. Maria Leaf on WMAL and WMAL.com.
Well, Washington's old American League baseball team, the Senators, didn't give the city much to cheer about, except when the slugging Frank Howard was at the plate. And tonight, Hondo is being inducted into the Ring of Honor by D.C.'s current baseball team.
I think it's long overdue.
Washington Post sports columnist Tom Boswell calls himself one of the original D.C. baseball fans, regardless of how painful it was.
There really was not an outstanding Washington team from like 1933 until 2012.
But the one bright star in the late 60s and early 70s, he says, was a home run hitter by the name of Frank Howard.
He was the most fun, joyful, oversized, Bunyan-esque character you could imagine.
He says Howard hit baseballs harder than he's ever seen before or since. The 80-year-old gets honored before tonight's Nats game against Colorado. Steve Burns on WMAL and WMAL.com.
Checking your money, the Dow right now up 90 points. The NASDAQ up 30. Up next, traffic and weather on 105.9 FM and AM 630. Washington's Mall, WMAL.
WMAL's charity golf tournament to benefit Operation Renewed Hope Foundation is Thursday, September 15th at Fort Belvoir Golf Club. Registration has been extended. Sign up as an individual or team now before it's too late at WMAL.com/golf. Registration includes a live broadcast with Brian and Larry, breakfast and lunch, plus meet Chris Plant and enter our raffle to win tickets to the Birchmere. Join WMAL, Operation Renewed Hope Foundation, and the Ventura Group as we strive to end veteran homelessness. Sign up now at WMAL.com/golf.
I'm Nick Soboleski, a SelectQuote agent with a true story that could save you hundreds of dollars a year. A woman named Linda just called. Her husband, Ray, has a $300,000 group life insurance policy, but is changing jobs and can't take it with him. Well, I impartially shopped the highly rated term life insurance companies we represent and found Ray, who is 41 and takes medication to control his cholesterol, a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $26 a month. That's almost twice the coverage for less than half of what he had paid. If SelectQuote hasn't shopped for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 1-800-457-1337. That's 1-800-457-1337. 1-800-457-1337. Or go to SelectQuote.com. We shop, you save. Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. Your price can vary depending on your health insurance company and other factors not available in all states.
1105 at 105.9 FM at AM 630 WMAL. Traffic and weather. Here's Steve Greenfield at Mahadeen Carpet Cleaning Traffic Center.
Thanks, Bill. We start off with an accident northbound on 295 after East Capitol Street. In the southeast quadrant, there's an accident. Police on scene at Massachusetts Avenue approaching the Randall Circle. In Prince George's County, there's water and sewer repairs going by. Just one lane gets by on Cooper Lane between Landing Way and Fairwood Road. And in Fort Washington, road work closes your right lane southbound Indian Head Highway at Livingston Road. In Fairfax County, Virginia, watch for a fender bender at the intersection of Franconia Road and Van Dorn Street. No access to the left or center lane. Traffic brought to you by Rivet Radio. Get the news and information you want when you want it. Rivet Radio lets you hear one riveting story after another. Customize your news to hear only what's important to you. Download Rivet Radio for iPhone, Android, or Amazon Fire. Now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Lots of sunshine this afternoon. The high 97. Partly cloudy overnight, the low 77. Tomorrow, sunshine 94. And Sunday, plenty of sun, the high 93. Right now, 90 in Stafford, 84 in Olney, 91 degrees in Washington. John McCain's Senate opponent says McCain is too old to stay in office. See the video at WMAL.com. I'm Bill Thompson on 105.9 FM at AM 630. Washington's Ball, WMAL.
Now, Chris Plant.
105.9 FM.
At AM 630.
Folks, like they've never seen before, and going to accuse decent Americans who support this campaign, your campaign, of being racists, which we're not. It's the oldest play in the Democratic playbook. When Democratic policies fail, they are left with only this one tired argument. You're racist, you're racist, you're racist. They keep saying it. You're racist.
Donald Trump yesterday. Now, the news media is very upset today. They have soiled their panties once again. Because Donald Trump yesterday referred to Hillary Clinton as a bigot again. And that is unacceptable, according to the news media. Now, you call Donald Trump and everybody that supports him and half of America racists and bigots and white supremacists and compare him to the KKK and lump him in with David Duke. And that's okay. They're all fine with that. Don't worry your little head about that. A double standard, and as we know, were it not for double standards, liberals would have no standards at all. Now, I gave Bruce too little time at the end of the hour back there, but Bruce, a 32-year veteran, saluting you. We ran out of time, but saluting you, 32-year veteran. And he's talking about the generations kind of lost in space because of our school system, where people come out of high school just sort of standing there with an empty bag saying, what do I do now? When was the Civil War? I don't know. When was World War II? I don't know. What's the Cold War? I don't know. Who's Ronald Reagan? Evil. Who's Jimmy Carter? Oh, he's so nice. Joe Biden. Oh, Joe Biden is so great. Obama, greatest president ever. It's pathetic. And I started to mention that we have had in the past, we had a great catastrophe with our audio library here a couple of years ago and lost everything that we had accumulated over the years. But we did have audio of the head of the teachers union in New York City with the head of the teachers union in Los Angeles having a powwow with someone recording it. They were unaware that they were being recorded, where they revealed that they had been surreptitiously infusing Marxist theory. I'm not making this up. We played the audio, and I'm sure we can find it somewhere, thanks to Al Gore, peace be upon him, and his amazing internet. We can probably find it again, but the union heads talking about infusing grammar school curricula with Marxist ideology, and I said, well, it's not there in the books, but you can fit it in. And the other teachers union people in the room were, oh, really? Oh, that's good. These are good tips. This is good stuff. And what's happened to our educational system is an absolute calamity. It's a tragedy. And the metric shouldn't be how we score in math against the Chinese. Let's face it, they're Chinese. But how well-rounded a person is when they get out, do they know anything about? And they're taught, as a third mention of Howard Zinn this week, I think, but the radical left dissembly of America is what they've substituted for history. The Los Angeles Times today with a headline, Trump calling Hillary a bigot is the tactic of a five-year-old. This is typed up by David Horsey. David Horsey. David Horsey boy. David Horsey typed up a little piece. Donald Trump has said many crazy things, some quite entertaining, many wildly fantastical and incendiary. Now he's outdone himself with this charge that Hillary Clinton is a bigot. What is, we were just having this discussion, see, because it's unacceptable to call Hillary Clinton a bigot, but you can call any Republican anything you want for as long as you want, as many times as you want. And David Horsey and his horsey sauce and his all that stuff, they'll be there to back you up. But we were talking about this because somebody said this morning that this whole immigration issue thing that Donald Trump seems to be moving on somewhat is his signature issue. And it might have been Michael Piercy this morning said, what is Hillary Clinton's signature issue? Hillary Clinton's signature issue. What is Hillary Clinton's signature issue? You know what it is? Genitalia. It's gender. That's her signature issue, that she'd be the first woman president. And to not vote for her would make you a misogynist. Right? You're anti-woman. And, of course, everybody's anti-woman, right? Anybody know anybody that's anti-woman? Anybody know anybody that's anti-equal pay for women? I can actually name a few people that are anti-equal pay for women. Like Barack Obama, who talks a good game, but in the White House pays women less than he pays men. Oh, then there's Hillary Clinton, which when she was in the Senate, where she actually gets to decide who gets what salary, as opposed to the State Department, where she does not, in the Senate, she paid women less than she paid men. And then there's the Clinton Foundation, which it has been established, pays women less than it pays men. So there are three examples, I guess, of people that don't believe in equal pay for equal work, but that's another thing altogether, I suppose. We have this doctor. This is a good thing. From CNN, this woman that was on CNN yesterday morning, and she's a doctor, don't you know? She's a doctor. She's in OB-GYN. Isn't that what Barack Obama called her, the OB-GYN thing?
OB-GYN?
She was on television. She's an OB-GYN.
OB-GYN.
And that's the President of the United States talking OB-GYN there. And she was being introduced by Chris Cuomo, who is a member of the Cuomo organized crime family in New York, New York. Because they brought the woman on, you know, Donald Trump got a note from his doctor, something, gastroenterologist, saying, never has anyone been this healthy in the history of humankind. And if you're talking about him serving as president of the United States, he's strong like bull, I think the letter from his doctor said. Got a note from his doctor. So CNN decided they'd start inviting doctors on to talk about Donald Trump's health. So naturally, they brought on Dr. Jennifer Gunter, who's an OB-GYN. She's an obstetrician and gynecologist. And CNN brought her on. She'd never met Donald Trump. She'd never been Donald Trump's doctor, I assume, unless there's something funny going on. And there's something we don't know, which if he does need an OB-GYN, that could bring over a lot of Democrat votes. So he should make it public right away. Chris Cuomo and Jennifer Gunter, OB-GYN.
All right, so there's this letter that was put out by Trump's gastroenterologist last year. Now it's under scrutiny. One doctor has recently written in the Huffington Post about what she finds most concerning about this letter. That doctor is Dr. Jennifer Gunter, an OBGYN, and she joins us now. Hey, Doc, so what don't you like about the letter?
I guess everything.
Oh, well, now we can see why she was invited on. She typed up a little piece for the party in the Washington Post. The Washington Post published it from an OB-GYN, and then CNN invited her on because she knows nothing about the topic. So, gotta have her on. I think she's the perfect guest for CNN in this particular regard. It's really, I think that our journalists are better than ever before. Speaking of CNN, let's go to soundbite number 17. Because CNN announced yesterday that they were firing Dr. Drew. Dr. Drew was fired by CNN. He had a show on Headline News there. But several days earlier on McIntyre in the Morning in Los Angeles, a radio broadcast, Dr. Drew made the mistake of saying that there might be something to this Hillary health thing, and that he was concerned.
I just called a friend of mine, Dr. Robert Heisinger, who's an excellent internist pulmonologist, and we just dispassionately sat and evaluated the medical record that she had released. And based on the information that she has provided and her doctors have provided, we were gravely concerned, not just about her health care, not about her health, but her health care.
You mean Hillary care? You mean Obamacare? You're concerned that she's got Obamacare and therefore she may suffer the consequences of having Obamacare? Hey, how much am I paying this month for Obamacare? Thank you, President Obama, for tripling, on the way to quadrupling, my monthly Dr. Drew.
If we were providing the care that she was receiving, we'd be ashamed to show up in the doctor's lounge. We'd be laughed out. She's receiving sort of 1950 level sort of care by our evaluation.
Dr. Drew Pinsky said that, and then he was fired several days later by CNN. Now, I'm just going to walk out on a limb here, and I'm going to guess that if CNN were asked about this, they'd say that it was a coincidence. Just like that airplane full of cash sitting on the tarmac, waiting for the plane with the hostages to leave Tehran, was a coincidence. So Dr. Drew Pinsky, looking for a job, if anybody's looking for a doctor, he is now available. He's gone. And number 19, CNN to Dr. Drew Pinsky.
You're just being pounded on. You're being out-debated. I just don't want somebody running one of my companies that's going to get beaten up so badly. You're fired.
Doesn't that sound like the Fareed Zakaria CNN music with the 72 Raisins thing? It's the same music. It's the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, The Apprentice, and CNN Fareed Zakaria 72 Raisins.
You're fired.
Dum, dum, dum. Imagine their surprise when they reach paradise, only to find that the Quran actually reads 72 raisins. 72 raisins? Can hardly believe that. Let's go to number four. Soundbite number four. I was watching the television, and as I do sometimes in the morning, and my DVR, which is a magic machine, records MSNBC, CNN, and Fox, and then I'm free to flip around and look at CBS and the Today Show. And they're really, you know, usually they're making pudding or splashing around in a splash pool outside or trying to comb Matt Lauer's hair or something like that. Mika Brzezinski, so you can get a lot of news out of those guys, that's for sure. Mika Brzezinski, whose father handed Iran over to the Ayatollahs, along with Jimmy Carter, James Earl Ray Carter, and is throwing the Ray. Mika Brzezinski this morning, I mean, she is a bedwetter of the first order. She's unbelievable. But, and I guess she still pretends to be a journalist or something, does she? She up for awards? Is that journalistic awards they pay her? I wonder what her job title is there. Mika Brzezinski this morning, and listened to a couple of sound bites, maybe one sound bite from Donald Trump, and then she plots or something like that.
We're just talking offset. I just have to say it. Donald Trump, you have no idea what your words mean. You have no idea. You have no idea what your words mean. And I can't pretend and sort of try and cover this fairly and put it in the veil of objectivity. This is wrong. You have no idea what your words mean and what you're doing to this country.
Yeah, but you do, Cupcake. She has the IQ of a lug nut. I'm sorry to lug nuts that may have overheard that comment. I'd like to apologize. She has no intention of covering it. You've never covered anything fairly, Cupcake. You're having an affair with Mo Yarbrough, which, you know, I'm glad somebody is, because it takes him out of the general population, theoretically. You know that they both, Mo Yarbrough and Mika Brzezinski, have both quietly divorced their spouses over the last couple of years, and they kept a secret, and they never, there was never any public anything, and the rumor has been circulating for years now that they've been boffing for ages, and I think Mike Barnicle is the third in there. I'm not sure. I think it might be. You have no idea, and she can't cover it fairly or objectively. You've never covered anything. And it goes to Jim Rutenberg at the New York Times, who wrote a while back, I believe he's the one a couple of weeks ago, that there's no reason that reporters should cover Donald Trump fairly, because they don't want to, and that's just who they are. And now, the Allman Brothers. But I have more. Oh boy, howdy, do I have more. Let me tell you right now. There's a lot of hate out there. Hillary is a burning, churning furnace of hate. Everybody's a racist except the people that are beating up white people in the street and shooting white cops. And everybody else is a racist, though. Everybody else said, and those white supremacists, you gotta look out for them. They might, I don't know, have a cattle ranch or something. But forget about the mass murder of police officers targeted because the Democrat Party put targets on their backs. Forget about the white people being beaten by violent black racist Black Lives Matter mobs in Milwaukee. Hey, stop beating him up. He's Asian. He's Asian. Oh, sorry. I thought you were white.
Keep it right here. I'm warning you.
You're listening to The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
Have you ever seen a real farm table? It's long and narrow, with the boards running down its length rather than across it. It was the kitchen's main work table, and every farm had one. Well, now you can have a classic farm table for your kitchen or dining room, for cooking preparation, project center, homework station, or writing table. It's made from reclaimed barn wood of grain-matched boards with particular attention paid to preserving classic lines and using techniques and finishes that give your farm table amazing depth, accenting the grain and the wood's aged beauty. It's from Shenandoah Furniture Gallery in Purcellville. These tables are prized, hand-signed heirloom quality, yet practical and hard-working. Want to see one before you visit? Go to ShenandoahFarmTables.com. That's ShenandoahFarmTables.com. Useful, practical, elegance. Shenandoah Farm Tables from Shenandoah Furniture Gallery, Purcellville.
Welcome to a place where all that glitters is yours for the taking. You can win a share of $70,000 in trips, cash, and more at the $70,000 kickoff giveaway on August 26th and August 27th. Start earning entries now. There's no place like Hollywood. Hollywood Casino at Charlestown Races. All gaming is regulated by the West Virginia Lottery. Gamble too much? Call 1-800-522-4700 for free confidential help.
When towers seem like trees and roads become rivers, the Range Rover Evoque is there to guide you through the twists and turns of the urban jungle. Gaze up through the available full-glass panoramic roof to take in the city from an unexpected angle. Lease the 2016 Range Rover Evoque SE Premium 5-door for $379 per month for 33 months with $1,000 summer credit included in lease payments and $39.95 plus taxes, title, and fees due at signing now through September 30th. Visit your local D.C. area Land Rover retailer or call 1-800-FIND-4WD for details. Land Rover, above and beyond.
Built for business. In business, time is money. In business, money is also money.
No wonder nearly 1,000 businesses choose Comcast Business Internet over DSL from the phone company every single day. Not only is it up to 5 times faster, it's actually a better value when you go with the fastest plan. So take a minute out of your busy schedule and call Comcast Business. It will be well worth your time and your money.
Switch to Comcast Business Internet. Then add voice and TV for just $34.90 a month. And ask about our 2-year price guarantee. Call 800-501-6000 or visit ComcastBusiness.com. Comcast Business. Built for business.
Offer ends 8/31/16. Restrictions apply. Limited to 1 voice line and private view TV for new customers. 2-year contract required. Requires Comcast Business Internet and an additional monthly charge. Equipment, taxes, and fees, including broadcast TV fee extra. Savings claim based on cost per megabits per second. Compares Comcast 100 megabits per second and 20 megabits per second DSL downloads.
Depression is treatable. At Greenbrook TMS Neuro Health Centers, we understand that often medication and talk therapy just aren't enough. With TMS therapy and FDA-cleared, non-invasive, non-sedating outpatient treatment, there is hope. Accepting most insurances, now including TRICARE and Cigna Healthcare. Treat your depression now. For your free consultation, visit HopeTMS.com. That's HopeTMS.com. Dr. Will Sauvay for Greenbrook TMS Neuro Health Centers.
TMS therapy stands for transcranial magnetic stimulation. It's a treatment that's been FDA indicated for the treatment of depression since 2008. Now with TMS therapy, it is incredible and pretty amazing for me to be able to watch someone get well from depression, see their life change, and see them being able to live their life the way that they always wanted.
To see how TMS therapy can change your life, visit HopeTMS.com.
If your credit card debt is out of control, if you're in over your head dealing with monthly payments, there's a powerful secret the credit card companies don't want you to know. If you have more than $5,000 in credit card debt, you have the right to settle that debt for a fraction of what you owe. That's bad news for credit card companies, but it's great news for you. We're Credit Associates, and we're offering you free information on how to virtually eliminate your credit card debt and make your monthly payment affordable. To see how much you could save, call now, 1-800-700-3515. Don't declare bankruptcy. Give us 10 minutes and we could save you thousands. We depend on your success and offer a guarantee, so there's no risk. Credit Associates. Live better debt-free. Find out how easy it is by calling now. For the secret the credit card companies don't want you to know, call Credit Associates now and see how much money you could save for free. Call 1-800-700-3515. That's 1-800-700-3515.
Rush Limbaugh, weekdays noon to 3 on Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
Found the video/audio of the teachers talking about infusing curricula with Marxist theology. But before I get to that, WNEP, Pittston Township, angered over sap, man cuts down tree, sending it onto his own apartment house. A man in Luzerne County cut down his neighbor's tree over the weekend because he thought it was ruining his car. The tree ended up hitting his own apartment house. Police said Raymond Mazzarella grabbed a chainsaw and cut down the tree in his neighbor's yard Saturday afternoon. The tree sat in his neighbor's yard, but it had branches above his parking space. Those branches would drip sap onto his car. When he cut through the 36-inch wide trunk, the tree fell onto part of his own apartment building. It's a pretty good-sized tree. He decided the best thing to do was to get rid of the tree. Where he thought it was going to go, I don't know, said Terry Best, the Pittston Township Code Enforcement Officer. Authorities condemned the building on Oak Street in Pittston Township, and 5 people have to find new places to stay. Rick Woods, who also lived in the apartment house until it was condemned, when the tree fell, Woods said he was in his apartment, sitting on his couch, watching TV. All of a sudden, he heard a big crash. I fought a tractor trailer, lost his brakes, and ran into something. Not realizing it was the house, he said. Police said Rossamella was being checked out at a hospital. Upon his release Monday afternoon, neighbors said Mozzarella saw Mozzarella trespassing near the apartment house and called police. Hey, hire a professional, why don't you?
I want to mine!
This is the Chris Plant Show.
WMAL-FM Woodbridge, WMAL Washington.
105.9 FM and AM 630. WMAL Washington. A Cumulus station. Where Washington comes to talk. News. Now.
WMAL News at 11:30. I'm Maria Leaf. The Food and Drug Administration wants all U.S. blood banks to start screening for the Zika virus. That's a major expansion intended to protect the nation's blood supply from the mosquito-borne disease. Meanwhile, Florida Governor Rick Scott says his state is winning the fight against Zika in the Miami Beach area.
We haven't had a new case in a little over almost 3 weeks now down there, so that's positive. We have two additional counties we're looking at on top of Miami-Dade. One is Pinellas, one case in Pinellas, one case in Palm Beach, and we do thorough investigation.
In earthquake-stricken central Italy, hope fading for finding more survivors in a grim race against the clock.
One of the things that's making that race against time that the authorities are in right now even more difficult is the aftershocks that we continue to feel here, especially right here in the epicenter of Amatrice. We had a massive aftershock here in this town. Actually, another building in the town collapsed after that.
Correspondent Frederick Pleitkin, the economy expanded at a sluggish pace this spring, as businesses sharply reduced their stockpiles of goods and spent less on new buildings and equipment. The Commerce Department says gross domestic product increased at an annual rate of 1.1% in the April to June quarter. WMAL traffic and weather. Here's Steve Greenfield in the Hadid Carpet Cleaning Traffic Center.
There's emergency road work on the outer loop of the Beltway by Central Avenue. The left lane is blocked. Plus northbound 295 after East Capitol Street. An accident knocks out one lane in Prince George's County. Just one lane gets by with sewer repairs on Cooper Lane near Fairwood Road. And in Alexandria, there's an accident at Duke Street by Roth Street. In Fairfax County, an accident shuts down Morningside Lane right by the GW Parkway. Plus, D.C. Metro's blue and yellow lines currently running with delays. Now from GarageDoorRepair.com, the WMAL Weather Channel forecast.
Sunny today, high 97, 91 right now at Reagan National. I'm Maria Leaf on Washington's Mall, WMAL.
Want to know the secret that those flipping houses gurus won't tell you? Is that flipping multi-unit properties is easier and more profitable than flipping single-family homes. With over 17 years of experience, we here at RE Mentor will show you the art of buying and selling multi-unit properties. Come spend the afternoon or evening with our team of experts, and we will show you how to put $10,000 to $30,000 in your pocket over the next 90 days. This two-hour class will teach you the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. You'll learn how to buy, hold, and sell multi-unit properties with no money down, no credit, and no risk. You risk nothing but have everything to gain. This intensive two-hour real estate class is coming to the DMV area soon. Call 1-800-863-7614 to secure your seat now. This seminar is free for the first 30 people that call. Change your life now and learn the art of the multi-unit flip or long-term hold. Call 1-800-863-7614. 1-800-863-7614. Call now.
Hiring people is probably the worst part of my job. It's such a hassle, the searching, the sorting through resumes. Most people don't have the right experience.
We started using ZipRecruiter about 3 months ago. Right from the start, you could tell it was going to make hiring a lot easier. One click and my job was posted to 100 plus job boards, all the top sites.
All of the candidates came to my dashboard, and it's easy to compare them. Thumbs up if I liked them, thumbs down if I didn't. No emails and attachments, printing up docs, phone calls, none of that.
And I couldn't believe the number of great applicants we got. I had the person we needed within 1 week. I don't know how we hired before ZipRecruiter.
Whether you're looking to fill one position or 20, find the best candidates with ZipRecruiter, where your job is just one click away from 100-plus job sites. ZipRecruiter, the fastest way to hire. And right now, you can try ZipRecruiter free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/work. That's ZipRecruiter.com/work. ZipRecruiter.com/work.
If you know the value of good machines, then it's high time we got together. We're Bailey Industrial, builders of metal and woodworking equipment, hardworking machines for hardworking people. Because better equipment means better work and getting more done. And keeping you working is what we do best. We stand behind our equipment and make sure our equipment stands behind you, offering you the after-sale support you need to keep your shop running smoothly, which means making sure you have what you need when you need it, typically shipping within 72 hours or less. So whether you're a hobbyist or a seasoned professional on deadline, go to Bailey.com now and we'll send you a catalog. That's right, friend. Over 400 pages of what you love most, machines. So whatever you're looking to build, repair, or manufacture, do it with Bailey Industrial, the company you can trust to give you the equipment and service you can rely on. That's B-A-I-L-E-I-G-H. Bailey. Because if it's worth doing right, it's only right to do it with Bailey. So go to Bailey.com now and pick up your free catalog.
From the start, Donald Trump has built his campaign on prejudice and paranoia. He is taking hate groups mainstream and helping a radical fringe take over the Republican Party.
Taking hate groups mainstream. Well, I think the Democrat Party's already mainstream. Let's go to the Nation of Islam. A couple of calls that we've gotten today. That didn't stay on the line. One person wanted to talk about the Southern strategy and say, what about this Southern strategy thing? Here's what I would recommend. I would recommend you go to the Google machine or the Bing machine, probably better than Google, but just Google Southern strategy myth, Southern strategy myth, or Southern strategy debunked. One of those. There's a New York Times piece there from several years ago. There's a Breitbart piece, Town Hall piece, several pieces on what a fraud this whole Southern strategy. That was that's the liberals' get out of jail free card. It's what absolves them of their history of sins on the racial front. The whole Southern strategy thing. It's like a Houdini trick. They can get out of their entire history in one fell swoop, a fell swoop. My mother used to say, Nicole Wallace, and so go and take a look at that, because it's kind of a convoluted discussion to have here, but it was something conjured up by the Democrats, and they've used it as an effort, as a means ever since to wriggle out of their history, and to, and in a trick like a judo move, put it all on the Republicans, and if you read about it a little bit, you'll see that it's just part of the big lie, the big lie. And another caller had another topic on the Obama has deported more people than Bush. So how can you say that he's, and of course that's a lie. And this morning I found a Los Angeles Times piece, because I know liberals only believe liberal outlets. The Los Angeles Times did a piece, it was about 2 years ago now, where they say, well, it looks like Obama may have deported more people, but in reality he has not. Because once again, like the unemployment numbers, like the economic growth numbers, like so many other numbers that this administration tampers with, they tamper with that number too. And they do it in a way that allows them to speak out of both sides of their mouths at the same time, so they can say that they haven't deported as many people to this crowd, and then go to another crowd and say, we've deported more people than George Bush. But the Los Angeles Times piece points out the fact that there are fewer people being deported from the United States, dramatically fewer, down 40%, according to the Los Angeles Times piece, under Barack Obama, 40% fewer people being deported from the United States. But they increase who actually reside within the United States of America. But what they did is they started counting every person at the border that's turned around and sent back at the checkpoint. That's, you check an ID at the border from a border patrol person and they're sent back. Or they started counting them in a new way. so they could spit up both numbers and leave a confused news media to sort it out. But they have no interest in sorting it out. So it's a win-win for the Democrats once again. Let's go to soundbite number five. Nicole Wallace pretends to be a Republican on MSNBC, and I'm sure she's a perfectly nice person. But she worked for the George W. Bush administration in the White House communications, and she's now employed by DNC TV. And this morning she was on Morning Joke on the Little Circle Fest there with the plagiarist and the brain-dead puppet and the sock puppet, you know, Mika. And she's got to be with the program, and the program is you're anti-Trump all the way when you're on MSNBC. And if you're called a Republican in your lower third graphic in your font, then that's all the better. And they like to have you go after Trump. She was particularly poetic this morning, and I don't actually remember this scene from the Rob Reiner movie. Was it written by Aaron Sorkin? I think it was written by Aaron Sorkin, directed by Rob Reiner as a liberal's wet dream. It was the Michael Douglas as president and Michael J. Fox as press secretary or something. And Nicole Wallace conjuring up scenes from Aaron Sorkin, Rob Reiner movies to sum up Trump voters. Not just Trump, but Trump voters. Trump is a mirage, and guess what you're stuck with now?
You know, the tragedy of Trump's candidacy is that there will be no wall. What he has promised people, and there's a scene in The American President where Michael J. Fox is pleading with the fictional president, and he says, people are so hungry for leadership that they'll crawl through the sand toward the mirage, and when they realize it's a mirage, they'll eat the sand. Donald Trump has his supporters eating sand.
Mm. Mm. My favorite part is Mika getting a little gratification at the end there, I think.
Mm.
Mm. I'm sorry, Mika, was that you? Did you like that soundbite?
Mm.
Mm. She likes that one. She likes it a lot. Mm.
Mm.
Reminds me of Rachel Maddow, because Rachel Maddow is, you know, she enjoys these things too.
Sloppy, beefy goodness.
And sometimes even more than that.
I'm vibrating off my seat at a height of about 6 inches.
Mm. Aim higher, Rachel Maddow. Aim higher.
Mm.
Mm. Mika, she loved that soundbite. Apparently she liked that movie. Maybe she just liked that movie a lot. I'm not really sure. And of course, the Democrats have no problem. They can't be associated with that. Black Lives Matter, and DeRay McKesson and the others invited to the White House before the conventions and apparently told not to ride at the conventions by our number one leading community organizer. That's President Barackus Husseinus Obamas. Salute. Black Lives Matter comes to the White House, right? And Let's go to number 15. And the Democrats and Hillary Clinton and the news media, but I repeat myself, are doing their best to equate Donald Trump with white supremacists. And Twitter is the death of everything. And Donald Trump has done a lot of dumb things, politically dumb things, flat-footed, tin-eared, just not smart things if you're running for president, some things you don't do. And Twitter, he doesn't know where it's coming from, and he doesn't know who it is. But Twitter is just death. Twitter is nuts. Twitter, if you're in politics, you should not be on Twitter. Period. But protests in Ferguson, Black Lives Matter. I mean, talk about racists and racist attacks, beatings, burnings of buildings, killing police officers. How many? 7 by Black Lives Matter people, 5 in Dallas, 2 in Baton Rouge, many more shot and wounded, 2 shot in Ferguson, Missouri. This is Black Lives Matter in Ferguson, Missouri. In white people's faces. She's yelling in white people's face, stormed into something that they weren't invited to, and they're be uncomfortable smack. You know, Ferguson, you're out, you're walking down the street chanting, what do we want? Dead cops. When do we want them now? Then they got lots of dead cops. And it's amazing. The New York Times never puts the two pieces together, and it never gets tied around Hillary Clinton's neck. Never gets tied around Barack Obama's neck. It never gets tied around the Democrats' neck. Two police officers assassinated sitting in their car in New York by a Black Lives Matter activist who then committed suicide. In Dallas, suicide by police officer. They've got suicide attackers, the Democrat Party, just like the radical Islamists do, just like the jihadis do. They've literally got people out there murdering police officers in suicide missions. And Barack Obama said with the police acted stupidly. Darren Wilson, the police officer in Ferguson, Missouri, Barack Obama's vilifying him at the United Nations to the world, equating Darren Wilson, who was completely cleared and exonerated by Eric Holder, who's a racist, too, at the Justice Department. 100 FBI agents swarmed into Ferguson, Missouri as part of a lynch mob. They were on horseback with cowboy hats and a rope, and they were there for Darren Wilson, but instead they ended up exonerating him. And Barack Obama has been demonizing the police. He's a radical. He's a lefty. He's an agitator, Barack Obama, a community organizer. See the New Republic piece from 2007 entitled The Agitator, where they talk about him and Saul Alinsky. They mention Saul Alinsky's name more than they mention Barack Obama's name. It was before he was running for president. And this is Barack Obama's America. But that's okay, because they're Democrats. How many cities burned? How many cities have burned? Man. And in Chicago, where another great story out of Chicago, I'm being facetious the other day with all of the crazy homicides there, day in, day out, weekends where they have 13 homicides and 56 shootings in one weekend, and nobody from Black Lives Matter is there chanting anything. It's kind of amazing. Should be, as I'm fond of saying, because it's true, if Black Lives Matter, you'd be protesting outside of a Planned Parenthood clinic in New York. And the Reverend Al Sharpton would be leading the charge. But you may remember a pro-life group, and it was African-American pastors, pro-life group, put up a billboard in New York City in Manhattan with a picture of a little girl, African-American girl, 8 years old or so. And the billboard said the most dangerous place for a black child in New York City is in the womb. And liberals went crazy, and they demanded that the billboard be taken down because it was true, and they don't want the truth out there. God knows the truth is not their friend, so they didn't want the truth out there. And who led the charge in taking it down but the Reverend Al Sharpton? I saw a picture of him today from years gone by on DNC TV, a picture of him with Donald Trump and Geraldine Ferraro, and he was talking about how Trump used to be good, but now he's bad. And what changed? Well, he said he was a Republican. He was great. He was the same guy when he was giving money to the Democrats, hanging out with an extremely corpulent, dirigible-like Reverend Al Sharpton, who's just, these pictures of him in the old days are astonishing. He could, five of him today could fit inside of the old Al Sharpton.
But resist we much. We must and we will much about that be committed.
See, and they say Trump can't read a teleprompter. That's he's a journalist, an award-winning journalist. Aren't they great? Aren't they wonderful? Let's go to soundbite number 24. There's a story out of Chicago with all the homicides going on. Reuters, the Chicago Tribune, carried the story. That the number of homicide cops, a couple more homicides day before yesterday, the number of homicide detectives dropping off a cliff in Chicago. Chicago's detective force dwindles as murder rate soars. You know why? Because it's hell. And because you just get dumped all over. And the Democrats there, Rahm Emanuel, Barack Obama's former chief of staff, my high school classmate, mayor of Chicago, doesn't have the back of the police officers who are out there putting their lives on the line every day trying to prevent murders and get murderers off the street. And then you get a murderer off the street, and the liberals are on the side of the murderers. And they attack the police. Number 24, Sheriff Mika Brzezinski, this morning on DNC TV. And this is journalism today.
I really don't want to add any type of emotional or political fury into this. This is not the way we want to win. But Hillary Clinton needs to win this election because this is sick.
Yeah, you're right. It is sick, but you're too stupid to understand what's going on around you. The Hillary Clinton ad is let's go to number 25. I don't even want to play the whole thing, but let's listen to a little. Here's the Donald Trump is the Klan. He's David Duke. He's white supremacist. This is just smear by association, and the news media is all in with it, as Mika Brzezinski speaking for the news media at large, and I have others speak for the news media at large as well from time to time, but today she'll have to suffice.
The reason a lot of Klan members like Donald Trump
here's the
is because
ad.
A lot of what he believes, we believe in.
Omar Mateen.
Donald Trump would be best for the job.
For president.
Yeah.
I am a farmer and white nationalist. Support Donald Trump.
Sending out all the illegals, building a wall, and a moratorium on Islamic immigration. That's very appealing to a lot of ordinary white people.
Running against Donald Trump at this point is really treason to your heritage.
Will you unequivocally condemn David Duke and say that you don't want his vote or that of other white supremacists?
I don't know anything about white supremacists, so I don't know.
And so yesterday, they're asking him, a reporter, we played the audio yesterday, do you want the votes of white supremacists? Well, Hillary, do you want the votes of Black Lives Matter? Now, which group has been carrying out racist attacks in America? Which group has assassinated people across America, from New York to Dallas to Baton Rouge? Which group is violent, racist, murderous, and bloodsopped? And which group is invited to the White House? You think Hillary Clinton will be asked about that? I'll bet you a dollar.
There's only one Chris Plant. The Chris Plant Show. Washington's Mall. WMAL. Where Washington comes to talk. Is your air conditioner not keeping your home and family cool during these hot summer months? Are those high energy bills taking a toll on your wallet? If so, call ARS Rescue Router. We're offering select heating and cooling systems at a low monthly cost of only $83 with approved credit. That's right. For a limited time, you can have energy-efficient comfort for only $83 a month. For details and to schedule your free estimate, call 888-2424-ARS or visit arsofvirginia.com.
Call ARS and Rescue Router.
Chris Plant here. Join me on Thursday, September 22nd for the best party in Washington all year. It's the Media Research Center's annual gala featuring the hilarious Dishonors Awards. Over 1,000 conservatives, including yours truly, enjoying a night of mingling, eating, and my favorite part, making fun of the liberal media. All the details are at mrc.org/gala. Enter the promo code Chris to get $100 off each ticket. That's mrc.org/gala. Promo code Chris.
Message and data rates may apply.
Hi, I'm Frank Thomas. When I was playing ball, they called me the Big Hurt. But after I left the game, Mother Nature started putting a big hurt on me. I just couldn't stay in shape like I used to. Turns out, it wasn't my fault. Once you hit 40, your body has less free testosterone, and that can make it harder to get into shape. But luckily, I found out about Nugenix.
Nugenix is a unique man-boosting formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help boost your free testosterone levels. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting ENERGY to 67076. With Nugenix, you can feel stronger, leaner, with a lot more stamina and energy.
And guys, she'll like the difference too.
Nugenix is GNC's number one selling men's vitality product. Get a complimentary bottle now by texting ENERGY to 67076. Nugenix samples are not available in stores. So again, text ENERGY to 67076.
At the Big Screen Store, Labor Day savings start now. Why not save 50%? Get a huge Samsung 75-inch 4K UHD TV. Originally $49.99. Now just $24.99.
Wow! Nothing like watching the big game on a big screen.
The Big Screen Store is the only exclusive Samsung store, and our prices beat Best Buy and warehouse clubs every time.
They even beat Amazon's prices.
And this is huge. We double the length of your Samsung TV warranty free. This week at the Big Screen Store, get a Samsung 65-inch smart LED HD TV for just $8.99.
For Samsung, now that's a great price.
Well, if you're shopping Samsung, the Big Screen Store is the only choice. Just ask our customers.
You've got to check out the Big Screen Store.
Their prices are amazing.
The Big Screen Store.
The Big Screen Store.
The Big Screen Store. Store locations in Maryland and Virginia.
Hi, I'm Dr. Alex McMillan of McMillan Sedation Dentistry. I can provide a range of implant restorative treatment options in a single pain-free visit. Here are the advantages of choosing McMillan Sedation Dentistry. I have over 35 years of experience, hundreds of hours of advanced training and certification to use a nationally recognized state-of-the-art implant treatment. Implants are a permanent and simple solution, the new standard of care for tooth replacement and denture stabilization. From a single missing tooth to an entire set of teeth, dental implants restore your appearance, speech, oral health, comfort, and self-esteem. With dental implants, we can also permanently replace your dentures, which means no more slippage or adhesives ever again. Smile big. Eat what you want. Call McMillan Sedation Dentistry today and make your appointment at 877-394-4511. Online at smileeasy.com. That's smileeasy.com.
Attention, men. If you have tried or wanted to try Viagra or Cialis, or if you've ordered an over-the-counter product in the last few years, Noxetril is an option that is completely private, has received tremendous reviews, and can be at your door in just days. Pharmaceutical companies dislike us because we present a real option to their higher prices and insurance limitations. After years of research, Noxetril has been developed and formulated in U.S. FDA labs, packed with the highest quality potent ingredients. Noxetril is a true breakthrough in male potency. This remarkable all-natural pill is being called Viagra on steroids and is known as a powerful winner by the adult film industry. So what are you waiting for? Call now and ask how to get your free supply.
Call now and get your free supply. Call 800-489-8194. That's 800-489-8194. Get fuller and firmer with your free supply. Call 800-489-8194. 1-800-489-8194.
105.9 FM and AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL, where Washington comes to talk.
The Arabic word for virgin has been mistranslated. The original word that was used in the Quran was the word for raisin.
72 raisins. Imagine the surprise of the terrorist who expected something completely different.
Yeah, Dr. Drew got fired, but Fareed Zakaria stays on at CNN. 72 raisins. Imagine the surprise. Now, here's some big news that I'm glad to see. Ed Henry, according to The Hill newspaper here in Washington, D.C., exclusive, Ed Henry returning to Fox News. Ed Henry will be returning to Fox News after an almost four-month absence from the airwaves. The Hill hears that Henry will return to the network this Monday. 45-year-old will do general assignment reporting and will no longer be the network's chief White House correspondent. Henry, who is married with two children, was sidelined by Fox management after In Touch magazine revealed an affair with Natalia Lima, a Las Vegas hostess. Lima shared revealing text messages between Henry with her and the publication. The Hill learned that Fox's plan for Henry does not include any reporting on the presidential campaign or any political reporting in general. Well, why? I mean, it's perfect for the Clinton household. How can you do that? Henry, formerly of CNN, I used to work with him at CNN, 2004, 2011, most recently covered the Hillary Clinton presidential campaign, and he was the only reporter asking any questions there. The only one. Now there are none. The role that has since been filled by Fox News veteran Jennifer Griffin, who is normally their Pentagon correspondent, and she is an outstanding Pentagon correspondent, to be sure. To be sure. Also, someone earlier called in and said Louis Farrakhan didn't support Hillary Clinton. He's supporting Donald Trump. And I looked that up. He has, in fact, called Louis Farrakhan, the minister Louis Farrakhan, Nation of Islam, Chicago, Illinois, friend of Obama's. He has, in fact, called Hillary Clinton. It's true. He's called her Satan. He calls a lot of people Satan, though. And he has not announced his support for Donald Trump. Quite the opposite. He has quite explicitly said that he's not endorsing Donald Trump. But he did want to give him an attaboy because he said he's not taking money from the Jews. I wonder whether there is any truth to that, too. Early on, Donald Trump said he wasn't taking any money from anybody. And that met with the approval of Minister Farrakhan because he said he wasn't taking money from the synagogue of Satan. See, there's more Satan there. Then he quite explicitly said that he's not supporting him, but setting that aside. Have a kooky weekend. Turn off the news a little.
Thanks for listening to the Chris Plant Show podcast from 105.9 FM and AM 630, Washington's Mall, WMAL. Listen weekday mornings 9 to noon for the latest. And download more free original content daily from WMAL.com.